welcome everyone to Kyle Field in College Station, Texas, where today we renew one of the oldest rivalries in all of college football. ABC and the CFA present Baylor against their rivals 90 miles away on Highway 6, the Texas A&M Aggies. Kyle Field, what a place, a spectacular place for a football game. The Aggies are so tough to beat at home, and they have won 10 consecutive Southwest Conference games. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Mark Jones, along with Tim Brandt, and welcome to Kyle Field. This series began back in 1899, and there have been many tremendous games. And you know, it's time, Tim, for the Battle of the Brazos, when the Yell Leaders from Texas A&M start to crank it up just a little bit. Texas A&M comes into the game with a record of 6-0, but still some questions at the quarterbacking position.
Mark, this is a team that has aspirations of winning the national championship, and the last thing you want is to have a quarterback situation where there is inconsistency, and boy, does that have the coaches worried. The situation is this. Jeff Granger's the starter. You know his story. It's been well documented. He's a baseball player, was one of the last guys cut on the Olympic team, but he's been inconsistent. As a matter of fact, he may come in, hit four passes in a row, then miss five or six in a row, and that has him concerned. Corey Pulick's one of the most highly recruited quarterbacks to come out of the state of Texas. I would not be surprised to see him come in this ball game. He was 4-for-5 last week. But boy, you talk about superstars. Here he is, Greg Thrill Hill. He's the tailback. You heard that in the pregame here on ABC Sports, and he will be the catalyst for this team. Put him in the backfield with Rodney Thomason. Look out, they are tough to stop. Meanwhile, for Baylor, Grant Taft makes his last stop here at Kyle Field. He'll step down as head coach after a long, long stay. 20-some years as head coach at Baylor. That'll be a motivational factor, but the guy that makes this team go is the quarterback, J.J. Joe. He is a very intelligent quarterback, makes excellent decisions. They run the load option, the veer, and so he'll either hand it off to the fullback, he'll run it, pitch it, or throw it. But it all revolves around him. I think he has to have a spectacular game today.
Well, you look at the all-time overall series, Texas A&M with the lead, but Taft told us before the game his team extremely inspired for this contest. The opening kickoff in just a moment.
In 1993, you'll have over 500 new car models to choose from, and you can be pretty sure that most of them will cost more than they did last year. But this one won't. The Lumina Euro Sedan from Chevrolet. You'll find the features you're looking for, but you won't find a higher number on the sticker. This year's Lumina, last year's prices. Pretty ingenious, huh? What else would you expect from the heartbeat of America?
Rockport has combined the lightweight comfort of its walking shoe with the rugged performance of its hiking boot. The Discovery Series by Rockport. It wasn't as easy as it looks. Rockport, you should be in our shoes.
The temperature never drops below Xerox. That's very important to remember at a time like this, when it's very cold and you've got to get going. Ah, you did remember Xerox antifreeze. The temperature never drops below Xerox.
Most people know State Farm sells car and homeowners insurance. Some people don't know State Farm sells life insurance, too. I'm State Farm agent Cecil Burt. Our life insurance policies, our prices, and our financial ability to deliver on our promises, plus the good neighbor service State Farm agents are famous for, have made State Farm one of the largest of all life insurance companies and an outstanding life insurance value.
State Farm sells life insurance.
Excuse me, you're the owner of this place?
Yeah, I'm one of them.
So you could buy any laser printer you wanted, huh?
Well, we bought an HP LaserJet printer.
But you could have bought any laser printer.
Yeah. Why?
Ah, just for the novelty of it?
I got enough novelty around here.
But isn't buying an HP LaserJet sort of like a, you know, no-brainer?
Nah, I think it's kind of like a brainer.
HP LaserJet printers. If it isn't a LaserJet, it's only a laser printer.
CFA College Football, this ABC Sports exclusive, brought to you by the Heartbeat of America, Chevrolet, and your local Chevy dealer. By Norelco patented lift and cut shavers, we make close comfortable. By HP LaserJet printers, if it isn't a LaserJet, it's only a laser printer. And by the die-hard battery, now with more power when you need it most.
Well, this was the scene last night at Kyle Field. Midnight yell practice. Thousands upon thousands of Aggie fans showing up en masse to practice their
yells and their cheers in anticipation of today's matchup against Baylor. And what a scene that was. One of the best in all of college football. Texas A&M won the toss, but they have decided to defer, so Baylor will receive the opening kickoff. Brandell Jackson is back deep, and that's Terry Venetulius to kick it off for the Aggies. One of the most accurate field goal kickers in the nation. And here's the kick. Jackson will not get a chance to run this one back, and they will start off on the 20-yard line. The starting quarterback, the guy we talked about in the opening, J.J. Joe, completing just 45% of his passes. He's thrown 7 interceptions, 9 touchdowns, but he makes very good decisions. And the diehard starting lineup, back to the receivers for the Baylor Bears. Mims is the leading rusher, while Melvin Bonner is their big play receiver. He is tall, lanky, and he can run. The offensive line is relatively young. That is their shortcoming, but they have matured over the last 3 or 4 games. First down and 10 for Joe. And they hand it off to Robert Strait, the huge fullback. And he stopped up at about the 21-yard line. Let's set this wrecking crew defense for you. Sam Adams last year was the newcomer of the year defensively in the Southwest Conference. The linebackers, as always, at Linebacker U, a very good group. Marcus Buckley was just named one of the finalists for the Butkus Award. And in the secondary, a very good one. Derek Frazier is the leader back there. He's an All-American candidate. Joe on the option tosses it to Mims. And Mims is backed up and gang tackled and jacked at the 26-yard line by Aaron Glenn. And that's Patrick Bates, the safety that came up to introduce Mims to the Bates Motel.
They still picked up pretty good yardage. And the reason is Buckley, Marcus Buckley, the outside linebacker, the Butkus Award semifinalist, had containment. And he got caught inside. They got outside of him. And then the secondary had to come up and support.
Very different, Tim, for Texas A&M facing this option offense.
Well, because it's such an aggressive defense, they run with the football and love the blitz. They cannot do that against this team. Everybody has an assignment.
Third down. The draw play. And Mims is tackled at the 28-and-a-half yard line by Larry Jackson, his inside linebacking spot, 6'4", the 242-pound sophomore from Rockdale makes the stop.
Number one rushing offense in the Southwest Conference against the number one defense. That's the confrontation. And that time the defense won.
That's Derek Frazier, the cornerback, back to receive the punt from Rhett Delaney. And this is a low punt that gets a nice bounce, a fortuitous bounce for Baylor. It goes all the way down to the 26 and going and going and going. And it stopped at the 22-yard line. Just underway in College Station in Kyle Field. A beautiful day on a 50-yard punt. Stick around.
Got stranded once. Never again.
Look, there's a reason more people go to Sears for a new battery than anywhere else.
Face another winner without a diehard? No way.
Only Sears has the diehard. Intespo cold cracking starting power. Diehard performed 3 times better than industry standards.
Out here, if you don't have a diehard, you don't have a prayer.
You can count on me.
Sears diehard. More power when you need it most.
Affordable Canon CJ10. The power of color is yours.
Get the power! Autumn at McDonald's, where our new oven-baked apple pies are ready with their golden, delicious apple filling. Buy one now, and your local McDonald's will donate 25 cents to Ronald McDonald Children's Charities. It'll warm your heart.
This man has 2 of the fastest feet in the world, but even they can't pump a brake as fast as this Chevy Cavalier's standard anti-lock brake system.
Oh, yeah?
Without ABS, no matter how fast your feet are, this can happen.
Whoa!
But to help you stop and steer on slippery surfaces, Cavalier's anti-lock brakes pump on and off up to 15 times a second.
Yeah, but can they do this?
The safety of ABS. What else would you expect from the heartbeat of America?
Hold it!
Olympic medalist Nancy Kerrigan joins Todd Eldridge in a star-studded competition. Sudafed Skate America International starts Sunday on ABC Sports.
I'm telling you, you got to love that Texas hospitality. First down and 10 for the Aggies. The ball is on the 22-yard line, and that man right there is Granger, Jeff Granger, the man we talked about earlier. 6'4", 193 pounds, a sophomore. Going to have to keep a close eye on his mechanics. And the diehard starting lineups, the backs and the receivers for A&M. Greg Hill, last year's newcomer of the year in the Southwest Conference, 1,216 yards on the offensive line. Wesley and Dawson are the guys that keep things on an even keel up front. First down and 10, the backs out of the offset eye. A handoff is to Hill. And he was lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. May have lost half a yard. The tackle by Albert Fontenot. As we set this Baylor defense for you up front, they play a 4-3. And Fontenot is joined by Lewis, Strahan, and Pearson. Fontenot is the guy to watch up there. The linebackers, Lashay Maston from Dallas' Carter High School, is the leading tackler. And in the secondary, they have made a lot of changes, and it'll be interesting to see how they react today. Second down, 10 to go. Granger, nobody open. And he is sacked back to the 12-yard line.
Well, the sack was by Burleson. Burleson came hard, but it was outside pressure that really forced him to go. Again, it was Fontenot that made that play. Now watch Granger. He can't find the receiver. So give a lot of credit after the play action fake to the secondary. Now look, he looks to the left, looks to the right. Now he feels the heat. Fontenot's coming. Fontenot chases him out. And here comes Burleson, and he finishes him off 42 with a pretty good stick. Grant Taft told us Fontenot is as good as any defensive end he has ever had at Baylor.
And you see how many sacks Baylor has on the year. Third down, 19 yards of real estate to go, and Greg Hill drops it, being wide open at the 17-yard line. So it's the Rockettes offense, 1-2-3 kick for the Aggies on their first possession. Won't see that happen many times. Greg Hill is a very good receiver out of the backfield, but that time maybe just a lack of concentration.
Defensive motto at Baylor is speed is everything. They showed it that time.
David Davis is seventh nationally in punting, a very healthy average, and he gets off a very healthy boot. Driving it all the way back to the 28, Trooper Taylor. And Taylor has a healthy return out to the 43-yard line. So, after a 58-yard punt and a 15-yard return, the Bears have good field position. We'll be right back.
If you depend on your truck to last, here's news you should never forget. Of all the Chevy trucks built in the last 10 years, over 98% are still going strong. That's more than Ford, more than Toyota, more than Nissan. Over the years, no other truck is that dependable, foreign or domestic. Only Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
You looked scarier 25 years ago.
Did I?
You looked scared.
I don't know. I thought I hit it well for an innocent girl.
You were innocent for the 60s.
Any regrets?
None. You?
Just one.
What?
That I waited 25 years to give you this.
The 25th anniversary diamond. A brilliant celebration of the loving marriage.
I've got goosebumps.
Well, you've given me goosebumps for 25 years.
You demand the same things from your car that you demand from your budget. Both have to go more places, last longer, and work harder than ever. So get Walmart savings on the motor oil engineered for today's smaller cars. Castrol GTX. Castrol provides maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown. And Walmart savings provide maximum protection against paying too much. Walmart. Always the low price. Always.
Have no fear, the forests are safe. But what you're looking at there is a lot of wood. They are getting prepared for the big showdown against Texas in a few weeks, Tim.
One of the biggest bonfires and pep rallies you've ever seen. It's a tradition here at A&M as they prepare for Texas. They got was running by there yesterday. A guy told me they cut down almost 300 trees, but every tree they cut down, they replace it with a new one. Taking kerosene, lacquering that thing up, soaking it down so it'll explode when they light it.
Burn, baby, burn. J.J. Joe on the option. He's got Reggie Miller, but he under- Carter throws him and now completes it down to the 18-yard line. J.J. Joe beat Derek Frazier on the play, a pickup of 39 yards and a first down for the Bears. They come out throwing. One of the dangers of this, we told you, everybody has a responsibility. You have to take the dive man, the quarterback, the pitch man. But if he decides to stop back and throw, you've got one-on-one coverage out here. Miller's a little guy, 5'9", 160 pounds, but look at him go up and adjust to this. And I'm telling you, Frazier had no idea where that football was. Big, big game, dangerous play, executed by Baylor. First down and 10 from the 18. They give it to Robert Strait, the big fullback who plows ahead for a couple of yards. Mark, that's exactly what we were talking about. This defense for A&M is a very aggressive blitzing style defense. They cannot play that way today. Today they've got to play more conservative. Somebody's got to take that dive man. Somebody's got to take the quarterback. Another guy's responsibility is the pitch man. And that leaves the wide receivers one-on-one out there. They don't throw much, but when they do, it's usually very effective.
A lot of pressure on the corners then. Second down and 7, the backside of the eye. The kick is for Robert Strait, who again plows for about 3 or 4 yards and a couple carpet burns. Strait goes 240 yards, but if you're thinking about going on a diet, use the scale that he uses, because looking at him before the game, I'd say he's more around 260. He not only has that size, but he's got speed. You know, he ran for over 8,000 yards in high school. He was a tailback then. Came here as the number one prospect in the state of Texas.
Third down and 2 to go. Inside the 20, the Bears are extremely efficient. The handoff is to the second man of the option, Bradford Lewis, and not sure that he got the first down. Going to depend on the spot. Derek Frazier came up nicely, along with Patrick Bates, the free safety from the secondary, made the tackle.
Mark, you talked about how effective Baylor is inside the 20. They've scored 23 of the 25 times they've been inside the red zone, inside the 20. And those two times they didn't score, one, the clock ran out on them, and then the second one, well, it was just straight ahead, they had a problem. But I'll tell you, they've been extremely successful inside the 20, as you mentioned.
And as they pull the chains out, let's have a look at Monday night's matchup here on ABC. The Buffalo Bills taking on the New York Jets. The Bills have struggled a bit lately. They had last week off, and before that, they lost their last two games. And first down for Baylor. That all starts at 9 o'clock Eastern time, Monday Night Football on ABC.
Jim Kelly's been having trouble with that throwing arm. Consequently, the Bills have been struggling. He's had problems with his bursar sack, and he has to get that thing drained a couple times a week. You know, this is the youngest football team in the 21-year stay of Grant Campbell's head coach, 21 freshmen.
Calls it his baby Huey lineup. The pitch this time to Mims, and that time the Aggies read it nicely, and number 40, Michael Hendricks, came up from his strong safety spot to make the tackle.
Well, I think you're right, but it's not so much reading it as much as Hendricks had the pitch man regardless, and he just stayed at home and worked his assignment. Now watch this. You'll see out of the left hand of your screen, all right, 94's got the quarterback, 40's got the pitch man. They do their responsibility. They don't try to help somebody else, and that works. See, the biggest fear for A&M today is that guys will start running with the football rather than just doing their own job.
Discipline, the buzzword. Second and goal. Robert Strait plowing ahead, and he gets down to the 3.5-yard line. And he was met by a troop of maroon jerseys.
How about that collision between Strait, 6'1", 240 pounds, ran head into 6'3", 235-pound Jason Atkinson. And I mean, they both went straight up.
And Baylor, they come to work and get it done quickly, outscoring opponents 41-10 in the first quarter. We have 8:32 to play in the first quarter. That's Jason Atkinson.
Baylor has scored first in every game except for Houston.
Third down, goal to go. And Kyle Field stands up en masse.
J.J. Joe wants a timeout. He almost had to. The 25-second play clock was about to expire. He didn't want to get a penalty, especially down on the 4-yard line. So very wisely, as Grant Tapp said, he's an intelligent quarterback, he very wisely looked up, saw it, and took a timeout.
We'll be back in just a minute.
Can a razor cut your beard below the skin without the blades touching your face? It can if it's a Norelco. Because inside the floating heads, our lift and cut system lifts the hair so when it's cut, it can drop below skin level without the blades touching your face. Are you shaving this incredibly close and comfortable? You are when you shave with Norelco. Norelco, we make close comfortable.
Chevrolet announces just about the last thing you'd expect from a car company. Lower prices. Believe it or not, this is for real. Chevrolet is lowering the price of every new 1993 Cavalier Coupe, Sedan, Wagon, and Z24 Coupe. No gimmicks or hassles, just straight talk and lower prices. Surprised? You shouldn't be. What else would you expect from the heartbeat of America?
The Rothmans' brand new family room is there because the State Farm agent was there with a family insurance checkup. You see, State Farm agents keep in touch to help keep your car, your home, and your life insurance up to date. Just a month after we added more coverage on the Rothmans' home and its contents, it was devastated by a fire. But thanks to our checkup, the coverage was there, and for the Rothmans, it made all the difference.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm.
Third down, goal to go for Baylor. On their second possession, they held the ball for 3:13, moved it 53 yards. J.J. Joe on the option will not make it into the end zone. No, but he's given them enough to go for it on fourth down. Now it's not as much of a gamble. They need 1 yard to get the touchdown. Marcus Buckley made the tackle at the 1 yard line as we take another look at this one. J.J. reading it. You think he's going to go up the gut, but instead, there's Buckley. Baylor brings in their jumbo package. Fourth and goal. I challenge the middle with straight. I'd use that weight and that power just to blast it. Mims straight and Crawford, and they didn't make it. They didn't make it because he fumbled it. He fumbled the snap. So the Aggies passed their first major challenge of the game on defense. He never gets the snap. You can see it hit the ground before J.J. Joe even pulls away. He's lucky he got it back. Didn't make any difference. It was fourth down. A&M gets it. And Joe is going to find out, or at least explain to the people upstairs, what happened on that play. New quarterback in now, Corey Pulig for A&M, and he hands it off to Doug Carter. We expected to see Pulig, not this early. They didn't waste time. That's how much respect they have for him. He's just a freshman. One of the nation's top prep players last year in high school. He was 4 for 5 last week, and his first pass went for a touchdown. That's getting it done quickly. He's got good size, 6'3", 205 pounds. He's mature beyond his years, true freshman. But he comes in a very inauspicious time here. Hand off to Carter again. And let's kick it back now to John Saunders in New York. John?
Clark Houston in Texas and Peter Gardner going to work here. Now, Kenny Neal's receiver is actually bumped out of bounds. The official rules that he's allowed to come back in because he bumped. Touchdown, 31-16 now in the third quarter. Mark?
All right. Mark, I was down in Austin last week, had an opportunity to have dinner with Peter Gardner. He's extremely confident. He's been through tough times, but he said they turned the corner by beating Oklahoma. They think they can go the rest of the way, and they know, he says, they know they can beat A&M. Strong statement. Big words and a big situation here, and A&M has a first down. Greg Hill out to the 16-yard line, exploding through the hole for a 13-yard pickup. Got a lot of room over that right side. And the Aggies have some breathing room. Greg Hill, last year's Southwest Conference Rookie of the Year. Watch Shoop, the tight end, get a block. He engages on Burleson. That's third down and 9. They've got to pinch everything to the middle, but they don't. They overrun the play, and Hill breaks it outside for the big gain, the first down. Our Carter and Hill in the backfield this time. Three-step drop, and it's batted down at the line of scrimmage by Albert Bonteno. Got one of those huge paws on it.
What a game Bonteno's having. He's had a couple of tackles. He forced Granger into a sack earlier. Now he comes and he bats this one down. And again, Grant Taft says he's the best defensive end, bar none, that he's ever had at Baylor. But the thing that he's most concerned with, Grant Taft, is the size of his team. It's not very big. A&M is. And he's afraid that his club's going to wear down, be overpowered. There's a look at Granger.
Absorbing things from the sideline on second and 10. Two wide receivers out to the top of your screen. The handoff up the middle to Roger Thomas, and he could score. One man to beat, and Thomas takes it in the house. Touchdown, Aggies. They are when they line up together. Look at Thomas break through. Once he gets to the secondary, there's nobody going to catch him. He came into this game with 372 yards and two touchdowns. They call this the Lion offense. Hill and Thomas in the same backfield. That time the Lion roared.
An 84-yard bolt of lightning for a touchdown, the longest run of the season for A&M. As Terry Venetulius adds the extra point, and the Aggies lead 7-0. We're going to take a quick timeout and come right back.
Just a hoot and a holler from Nashville's Grand Ole Opry is another place that's home to musicians from all over the world. It's Groon Guitars, where they sell rare and vintage instruments to everyone from Johnny Cash to Motley Crue. So if you go, remember, bring your pick and your Visa card. Because at Groon, you can take your licks on a 1939 Martin, but you can't take it home with American Express.
Yeah.
Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
You own some Zadko, right? Think I should sell it?
I got out weeks ago, right after my broker's firm downgraded the stock. Now don't tell me that your broker's still hot on it.
Who knows? I use a discount.
A discounter? What do you think? It's just because you know how to make money, you know how to invest it?
Well, I just thought that, you know.
I've got a terrific guy over at Payne Webber. Call him.
Come on, how's some broker gonna know what's right for me?
He'll ask.
I see your printer here doesn't boast the HP LaserJet name. Did you ask for this?
No, I didn't. I assumed when I asked for a laser printer, I'd get a LaserJet.
Huh, have you spoken to management about this?
I am management.
Oh, so how did this happen?
Poor management, I guess.
Nah, probably just poor communication.
Yeah.
Maybe you ought to send yourself a memo.
Yeah, and I could make a point of specifying an HP LaserJet.
Yeah, don't mince words either. HP LaserJet printers. If it isn't a LaserJet, it's only a laser printer.
Welcome back. You know, I spoke with Rodney Thomas yesterday, asked him how it was going. He said, Mark, if it was going any better, I wouldn't be able to stand it. One of the most pleasant young men I've met ever. There's that Lion offensive attack, Mark, that we were talking about. You can see how productive it has been. When you have two guys in with the caliber of Thomas and Hill, you lose your keys. You can't lock one to one. You've got double trouble, and it's very difficult. You have to now split the defense. Venetulius to kick it off. Brandell Jackson, the deep man, for Baylor. 7-0 for Texas A&M. 5:37 to go in the first quarter of play. This one, unlike the first, will be returnable. Jackson at the 4. And he takes it out to the 24-yard line. The freshman from Branham High School here in Texas is tackled by Antonio Shorter.
You know, one of the great traditions here at Texas A&M actually started many, many years ago, Dana X Bible. And then Jackie Sherrill came in. He had all the students, non-scholarship players, just students, out of the student body come on, and they were on the kickoff teams. Well, now they just use one. But watch this. Here he comes. He is just elevated for this game. Boom, knocked on his butt, but he gets in the middle of the play. Congratulations to him.
Julius got a little TV time there. And on first down, they run the ball out to the 24-yard line.
We were looking at Julius Holly's mom earlier. 12th man's mom, she was as excited as he was.
And she's got a button to prove it, too.
All the moms wearing buttons today, telling who their sons are, which is another great tradition here at A&M. This place is fun. This is college football.
No, you don't have double vision. We're all wearing the same number.
The quick out to Reggie Miller, and it's incomplete. Miller is a guy last week that scored two touchdowns, both of them coming on reverses. And I'll tell you something. Miller, again, had leverage on Frazier. He worked his way to the outside. Had they gotten it to him, he had plenty of room on the sideline.
That sets up third down and 11 to go.
You know, this offense, we call it the beer, but it's just very much like the wishbone with a tight end in the backfield.
That's Melvin Bonner in motion. Joe rolls out and is looking downfield to Bonner. He might have him. Good position that time by number 31, Aaron Glenn, who was stride for stride with Bonner. 5 foot 10 inch, 180-pound junior with a nice defensive play.
Look at Bonner when he runs. He just kind of glides. You know, he's 6 foot three, so he's tall, looks angry. But he was a high school track star, athlete of the year. We saw him last year average 26 yards a catch. He's got those long strides and receiving speed. Became the defensive player there and stopped the interception.
Derek Frazier standing on his own 30, and there's a whistle down on the field. Rhett Delaney averaging 40.3 yards per punt for Baylor.
They had movement, so they'll back him up. Things not going well for Baylor.
Red ball, false start, offense, fourth down.
I think Baylor really needed to get off to a quick start against A&M. Here's a club that's unbeaten and going after the national title. You're playing in their house. You really have to come out and try to quiet this crowd, silence it a little bit with some success.
See if they can rebound from failing to score on the one-yard line. Delaney this time with a low line drive punt. Fielded at the 40 and dropped by Frazier. And he's down at the 45-yard line, a 42-yard punt by Delaney. Well, at the conclusion of today's game, we'll be selecting a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game from each team. And for the 22nd year through the Chevy Scholarship Program, $1,000 will be donated to the General Scholarship Fund of each school. Texas A&M used to be an all-military school way back. The rivalry between Baylor and Texas A&M was heightened when a lot of the all-male students in Aggieland used to make googly eyes at the Baylor co-eds.
Greg Hill fumbles it. And Baylor has the ball at the 48-yard line. Boy, there you have it. A big play turns things around. You know, Baylor uses that more complex overshifted 4-3 defense, not much blitz. They use the secondary line linebackers. Now watch how they come up this time. All right, there's a standoff at the line, which forces him outside. And then Hill is hit by Lewis, and his helmet actually hit the ball and just knocked it out.
And Michael McFarland made the fumble recovery. So, as a result, Baylor with extremely good field position at the 48-yard line of Texas A&M.
You know, last year that Baylor secondary started out the weakness of the defense. Understandable. Mike Welsh, Charles Bell, and Malcolm Frank, they were all gone. Now the secondary's playing well together.
The backs are stacked in the eye. Joe hands it off, and they run it down to the 42-yard line. That was Kendrick Bell, the sophomore, goes just 160 pounds. Both tailbacks for Baylor are a little bit on the small side. Mims going just 186.
Well, all the way across the board, up and down the depth chart, it's not a big ball club. If Bell comes in and does give Mims a breather, he's carried the ball 41 times this year for 290 yards. They both average 7 yards per carry.
Seven on first down. This time to give us up the middle, over the 40, inside to the 39. John Henry with his first carry of the afternoon. Another one of those big fullbacks. Adams and Marcus Buckley made the tackle.
You know, Grant Taft, his philosophy is that of the traditionalist. He uses the run to set up the pass, and when everybody went to the run and shoot, he stayed with the load option. But I think right now, you've got to get J.J. Joe
to use that option and get outside and really stretch the corner. Work on the perimeter a little bit, which would open the middle back up the straight. Maybe key in their success. Here's Joe on the option, getting to the corner. And they have the first down. Kendrick Bell. To the crystal ball.
Proves to be true, and it's working.
Well, I think, you know, he had to do that. I think Grant Taft felt the same way. Let's stretch it a little bit. Baylor now has used six different players carrying the football, so they're really spreading the wealth. Look at this. How impressive is that? We told you the number one rushing offense in the Southwest Conference, and it's against the number one defense.
And they've moved it well so far this afternoon. They failed to score last time inside the 20. Joe drops back to pass. Three-step drop and incomplete to the far sideline. But hit Reggie Miller. He was tackled by Derek Frazier. Well, next Saturday on ABC Sports, Fred Couples, Tom Kite, and the PGA Tour's top 30 money winners take aim at the season's biggest prize, the $2 million Tour Championship begins. Then ABC's College Football presents regional action. Many of you will see Stanford against number one Washington, Georgia, Florida, and Ohio State against Iowa.
Mark, J.J. Jones missed his last three passes.
The handoff again, and this time they can't get to the corner. Tackled at the 35.
Jesse Cox got out there in a hurry to make that stop. This defense led the nation last year. And if there's one thing they do as well as anybody in the nation, it's run to that football once it gets to the corner.
Linebacker U of the South. Third down and nine to go. Kendrick Bell checks out. And Melvin Bonner is split to the short side of the field.
See this graphic. You know, since 1985, 45 A&M players have been drafted by the NFL. Eight last year.
Joe almost stumbles. And he throws back against the grain to the tight end, Mike McKenzie. And he has a first down and then some. McKenzie all the way down to the 4-yard line before he's tackled by Patrick Bates. But not before a huge pickup of 31 yards.
When that play developed, it looked like J.J. Joe was adjusting. But now I think this was a design play. Watch it. He goes back, fakes. Now he'll roll to the right and look back. He's got his tight end dragging across the middle. McKenzie's a load. 6'3", 243 pounds. Watch him try to stop him. Hop on. Let's go for a ride. Down inside the 5 to the 4. Now, this is where they were before. They had first and goal down here and couldn't push it in.
Something that usually doesn't happen. The Baylor team that is very deficient inside the 20-yard line. 1:40 to play in the first quarter and a timeout by the Baylor Bears.
Now, this happened last time. They got down there and J.J. Joe called a timeout. Again, the play clock was down to 4. I think he was very, very concerned about the fact that he wanted to make sure he did not get the penalty. But again, they used their second timeout.
It was interesting, I think, to point out on that last play, saw some of the A&M linebackers, namely Marcus Buckley, blitzing, and that time they happened to make the right call, a big pickup.
Well, if there's one thing you want to do, is take advantage of that aggressiveness of the defense. Let them run themselves out of the play, at least out of their spots, their positions. As you saw, he crossed, and there was nobody in that area.
Now, you look at the style of this offense by Baylor, namely the Veer option, a great equalizer of talent, isn't it?
Well, it really is, and I think what really makes it difficult is the fact that they will use motion in different formations, which makes it difficult to defend. First of all, you've got three or four options on every single play. Now you show them different formations, you can't read it. You lose your keys. So yes, it is difficult, especially when a defense like A&M sees the run and shoot so often and the spread offenses and the more conventional attacks.
I thought it was kind of interesting, speaking with Grant Taft, that he's not caught up in this passing fancy that seems to be the wave now in college football. Still talks about running the football.
I think it's actually going the other way now. I think everybody's tasted it, and they see that it has some shortfalls, and so now they're going back to the power.
Jackson in straight. And straight ahead down to the 2.5-yard line. Marcus Buckley made the tackle that time for the Aggies. So it'll be second down and goal. The ball was spotted right at the 3-yard line.
Just lost his footing on this. Watch, he gets tied up with the dive man. You see his right leg? It leg whipped J.J. and J.J. goes down. Old man made the tackle. We talked about how strong they are inside the 20.
and the success they've had. Well, they're 0-for-1 today. That's a great credit to A&M.
That guy again. Great Crawford. And they power ahead near the goal line with Robert Strait, but he didn't get in. Pounds it down to the 1-foot line. Brent Tepp wondering, what do we have to do to get in?
Well, I'll tell you something else, too. That was closer to being a touchdown than you would think. He was actually bowling past the guy. His knee hadn't touched, and he was trying to reach across the invisible plane. That ball is inside the one, almost touching the goal line.
Well, they were here before. Let's see what they do this time. Strait is the up back, and Jackson is the tailback. And Strait looks like he broke the plane, but no signal yet.
Now they're going to mark it at the line of scrimmage. And I'm not sure his knee hit the ground.
From our angle, Tim, it didn't look like Robert Strait was down. Buckley and Kiefer Chatham made the tackle.
It did or it didn't?
No, it didn't look, like he
was down.
Watch
his knee. His knee did not touch. That's a touchdown. They misread it and said his knee touched.
Well, that was the last play of the first quarter, and Grant Teff has good reason to be upset about that call. We're going to take a short break and come back. It'll be fourth and goal for Baylor.
This Chevy Lumina is made of steel that's so rust-resistant, it's covered by warranty virtually until the end of this century. So, no matter how life changes by then, your Lumina will still look beautiful. 6 years or 100,000 miles, that's our guarantee. What else would you expect from the heartbeat of America?
The Postal Service would like to present two-day priority mail. That's delivery in just 2 days of up to £2 for just $2.90.
Two!
Remember,
two!
2 days, £2,
£2.90. Two! Two! Two!
Two-day priority mail from your Postal Service.
We deliver for you.
For pickup service, call 1-800-222-1811.
Tell you how it feels when you're way out there on your own tracking the bad guys. How it feels leading a skilled team that's the eyes and ears of the whole outfit. When all your training is coming alive. Finding those tanks and telling the air cavalry right where to hit them. I can tell you exactly how that feels.
Guys! Not gonna believe this. To hear Mike was named a GTE Academic All-American. Everything comes easy to that guy. I'll bet he doesn't even have to study to get good grades. And he spends half his time at the pizza place.
The GTE Academic All-America team was created to honor outstanding student athletes like Mike, because we know not everyone gives them the recognition they deserve.
Again, the ball is bobbled just like they had on fourth down last time at the other end. And Baylor, two times inside the one today without a touchdown.
Why would they, how could they possibly bobble the snap twice in a row? Is that crowd noise? What is it, miscommunication?
Whatever it is, they better get it taken care of. But look at Grant Taft. He's not happy with it, and he doesn't know what the problem is either. In 21 years of coaching here at Baylor, it's got to be some of the most frustrating things that he's seen in the last couple of years. Kolig still in the game, going up top and incomplete at the 30-yard line. Well, statistically, Baylor did move the ball well in the first quarter. Twice, they moved it downfield. We're not able to score, though.
Yeah, but look at this, Mark. First of all, look at the plays. Baylor's had 23, A&M just 9. All right, so now you come down and you look at 110 total yards for Baylor, 92 for A&M, and 84 of those came on one play, the touchdown run. And then look at the time of possession. Baylor has dominated in time of possession, which obviously is the best defense because it keeps the ball away from A&M.
Bullock backed up on the one-foot line. He hands it off to Carter for a gain of 2. Let's go to New York and John Saunders. John?
Clark Houston in Texas, and Jimmy Klingler here spots up and finds Freddie Gilbert, who's wide open. But watch the nice move there to shake off the defender. 38 yards, but Texas leads 31-23.
Freddie Gilbert, one of the top receivers in the nation. Just underway in the second quarter, third down, 8 to go. Pulling from the end zone to throw underneath to Doug Carter. And Doug Carter pushes it out to the 28-yard line and backed up to the wall. A&M with the first down, a pickup of 25 yards that time. Boy, that's a big-time play for Pulley. What 61 on defense here? He starts to go to the right. All right, now here comes the receiver underneath. Look at that. Therein lies your problem because Carter just ran by his linebacker, was wide open, and got the big gainer. But the Pulley, a lot of composure in the end zone and slowly gaining some confidence. That man told us yesterday that we should expect to see him. He paid off on that early, too. That's Rodney Thomas, who scored a touchdown in the first quarter on a long run. This time he picks up just about 2 yards.
Yeah, but I think they're going to move Texas A&M back for holding. Good call. They locked on right off the snap.
Tony, offense, their first down.
That's Joe Thomas, our referee, and he's been officiating a long, long time. Well, we had fun last night, didn't we? We went to see a high school football game right down the road. And
alumni baseball game.
Chuck Knobloch and Livingstone and the Tigers, they were all there.
And Knobloch grounded out.
A little 6-3 action for Chuck. Pulling now out of the backfield of the flat for Rodney Thomas. Pardon me, Greg Hill. The bookend running backs run so much alike, and Hill pushes it out to the 27-yard line before he's finally tackled by Lashay Mastin, the leading tackler on that Baylor defense. But a pickup of 11.
I watch Hill, and I just shake my head. You know, he set the Southwest Conference record for freshman running backs last year, the rushing record previously held by Earl Campbell. You see his statistics today for Pulley, but Hill is the guy. I think with that success, he lost the element of surprise, but then with Thomas stepping up, it takes the heat off Hill again.
And he's improved his numbers over the last couple of games. Hill with the carry again. And he picked up 2 yards. You know, you talk about Hill and Thomas, the line offense, the two players, like I said, are so much alike, but they are so humble, so very sincere. They compliment each other on their successes. And, you know, it's just part of the R.C. Slocum team credo. He preaches family and discipline and teamwork.
You know, Greg Hill's mom will be happy to hear you say that. They got a little bit upset last time. We said he was a little bit bravado, saying he could rush for 150 yards. And we said, well, you took that out of context.
Which it was. Pulling now. And it's dropped at the 42-yard line. Ryan Matthews had it in his hands but could not hold on. And the Aggies will have to punt. But Corey Pulling put that one right on the money.
Here's Fontenot again, and he's putting the pressure on Pulling. Look at him. Look at the push. 6'4", 243 pounds. Real good speed, good move. Powered him all the way to the backfield, and I guarantee you Pulling could feel him coming.
Dave
David Davis to punt. Brandell Jackson back deep with Taylor. This one's returnable. And they call for the fair catch. Jackson does at the 30-yard line. A 43-yard punt. Baylor with the ball when we come back.
I ran into David Perry over the weekend. I haven't thought about him since he retired. He sure ain't living like he used to. Something we have to look forward to. Actually, when I started with the company, I talked to my broker at Payne Webber. He felt that our retirement plan wouldn't be enough, so we decided I should be putting some money aside.
How do you even know about our plan?
He asked.
Our team project was tough. The deadline was tougher.
Only one digital color printer prints in black and white and color at the same time to save time. Intelligent color for any document, only from Xerox.
Putting it together.
Our spring fashions are terrific. Now let's get them noticed.
Highlight your news with Xerox Color and you'll get everyone's attention faster. Intelligent color for any document, only from Xerox.
Putting it together.
In the beginning, there was only one vehicle of its kind. Today, it's the only one to combine a lease this powerful with one this secure, this comfortable, and this affordable. The extraordinary Chevy S-Blazer lease plan. From the extraordinary vehicle that originated the species, Chevy Blazer.
They beat Notre Dame. Now Stanford has their sights set on number one Washington or other team conference matchups. It's regional action next Saturday on ABC's College Football.
Interesting statistic here. I want you to look at Baylor, 70 yards. J.J. Joe is 2 for 5 getting those. And what they've done today is break tendency, because normally, if you show what they've done play selection-wise, they're 75% run, 25% pass, but they've used the pass very effectively today and very productively.
And they roll out to pass again. This time he completes it for first down to Reggie Miller at the 43-yard line. So they continue, Tim, to break tendency.
Well, I think any time you can break predictability and get away from what you normally do, you've got that element of surprise. And right now, it's the A&M defense that has to adjust. Do you realize if you take away Thomas's 84-yard touchdown run for A&M, Baylor has dominated this game. Twice they've been inside the one. They've dominated time of possession, and A&M's been unable to move it.
And they run the ball with the fullback this time, Bradford Lewis, out near midfield. He's tackled by Jason Atkinson. But again, another 5-yard chunk on first down. Make that 8-yard chunk.
What do you do?
Second down and 3 to go.
Look at this. It's like a quiz. What do you do? All right, now what do you do?
Well, they're doing something right.
Guys, quizzing all the guys. Make sure they've got their heads still screwed on right.
Joe on the option. They give it to the fullback, and he's stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. That's Lewis again. Lewis, 5'8", 203 pounds, a junior, tackled by the Butkus Award nominee.
Watch number 9, Buckley comes up outside, ends, maintains his leverage. He's strong, too. 8 sacks on the year, and just the other day, they narrowed those Butkus Award candidates down to the final 10. He's one of them. Jason Atkinson was a candidate, but he was eliminated.
Joe on the option, pitches it to Mims. Mims driving hard, and he's out of the first down. Pushed out at the 46-yard line. The little man put his hat down on Michael Hendricks, the safety.
He knows the difference between come here and sick him. I'm telling you, Hendricks moved back about 5 yards when he made that hit. It's the defense that's supposed to pack the punch, but little Mims, 5'9", 186, came up and said, how do you do?
Hey, he took on Solari with those 225 pounds.
Grant Camp describes him as a will-o'-the-wisp type runner. That time he was a power back.
And he gets it again. Those shoulders got to the 40-yard line that time. Well, tonight on ABC, a special episode of Dinosaurs on a special night, followed by Richard Knoll and Rhea Perlman in The Last Halloween. Then Covington Cross at a special time, followed by Michael Chilkis starring as the Commish. All coming up tonight on ABC. Baylor University just 90 miles away on Highway 6.
Say what you will about the run and shoot, but it's explosive. It scores quickly. A couple of quick touchdowns in that game between Texas and Houston, now tied at 31.
We're back. And so are the Bears, powering down Bradford Lewis down to the 30-yard line.
Yeah, but Lewis put it back on the ground again. You know, that's 19 fumbles now, and 9 of them have been lost this year. But for some reason, they put it down on the ground a lot. They've just been fortunate to get most of them back.
Another first down for the Bears.
Watch Lewis. Let's see what causes this fumble. Oh, it's the hit from behind and then the strip coming across. Just kind of raked them.
First down and 10. Melvin Bonner lined up slot right. Miller is outside of him. And Joe falls down and couldn't hand the ball off.
You know, J.J. Joe keeps getting tied up with the fullback, the dive man. That time Lewis came through, and I think Lewis thought he was going to hand it to him. Instead of just riding it in his belly and pulling it out, J.J. went down again.
Brett Taft saying, go forward.
Reminds me of when our spotter Billy Breslin was playing. He'd never let him pull that ball out. Once it was there, he's keeping it.
Hold on to it like life. 2 yards on that last play, second down and 12. Joe on the pitch to Mims. And Mims has a first down. Move those sticks, fellas. The Bears on the move. After that pickup of 13 yards, Patrick Bates, the safety, made the tackle.
All right, give J.J. Joe all the credit here. Mims got the first down, but it's Joe that made the play. Again, he's got a read. Now watch. He'll first fake to the fullback. Bang. Now he'll come down. There's pressure there. He's got to get it out quickly. He does without even looking. Just throws it to where Mims is supposed to be, led him perfectly, and they get the first down.
Well, J.J. Joe has a calming effect on this very young Baylor team, and you saw some of it right there, his poise.
This offense, Mark, this offense really is a combination of everything that has worked for J.J. Joe.
A handoff is for Bradford Lewis that time, and he was lucky to get a yard, tackled by the nose guard, Eric England. England moved to nose guard and is doing a fine job. Didn't start the season there. They switched Teichelman in. A lot of people made the trip down from Waco, about 90 miles away, to watch this game.
Mark, listen to how this offense has been functioning. 405 yards against Houston, 520 against TCU, 489 against SMU. That's productivity.
A hand up on the draw this time to Brandell Jackson, a local product, and he's tackled at the 18-yard line.
Good tackle by Larry Jackson. Wouldn't let him go. Just wrapped him up and wouldn't release him.
Well, if you're Baylor right now, you're thinking that you have to cash in with either a field goal or a touchdown right now, because otherwise it's very discouraging.
Here's another trend that has been reversed. We told you the success they've had inside the 20, but you see, Baylor today is 0 for 2, and that's inside the 1.
Third down, 9 to go. Bonner split to the bottom of your screen. They line up slot left. Nobody open, and he steps out of bounds to the 22-yard line. So it'll be time to send in the field goal unit led by Trey Weir.
Trey Weir, 6-for-8 in field goals this year. He had one block last week.
This field goal, Tim, will come from about 39 yards out.
He does have a tendency, the farther out he gets, the lower the kick is. That's why the one last week was blocked at the line of scrimmage. The other miss was a high snap. He's very accurate.
From 39 yards away, Trey Weir. And it's good. So they were down deep 3 times, and on the 3rd opportunity, the Bears finally put some points on the board. 7-3, good ball game. We'll be back in a minute.
This isn't your typical car commercial. There's no beautiful scenery, no winding roads. Hey, there's not even a car. But there is news. Geo is lowering prices on the Metro Coupe, Sedan, and the XFI. So now the car that gets the highest gas mileage in America is also the car with the lowest price, which is pretty beautiful, even without pictures.
Get to know Geo Metro at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
In Europe, things happen on time, right on schedule. Punctuality is the norm. And that makes Europe the ideal environment for UPS. Fact is, UPS has built the most comprehensive delivery network in Europe. So when you have a shipment going there that has to be on time, use the delivery company whose punctuality is a time-honored tradition. UPS. We run the tightest ship in Europe.
The temperature never drops below Xerox. That's important to remember at a time like this, when it's very dark and very cold. Ah, you did remember Xerox antifreeze. The temperature never drops below Xerox.
In a world of constant change, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the rock. The Prudential Rock Solid.
Station, Mark Jones and Tim Brandon. The Yale leaders in hump position, and look at Reveille 5. Taking into action. Reveille, take it away. Let's hear a little bit. That's it. No, come on, a couple more times. Thank you.
We got him trained.
Absolutely. All right, but I'll tell you what. Now let's go to the other mascot. Here's the Baylor Bear. Which one would you take in a fight?
The Bear in three rounds. TKO.
All right, so Reveille can sing better, but I take the Bear in a fight.
Oh, boy.
Man, now if I could get my own dog to act that way.
I tell you, I'd get that bear to guard my house anytime.
Mike Chilton to kick it off for Baylor. 7-3 after that Trey Weir 39-yard field goal. And this one will not make it. Out of bounds at the 17-yard line and a flag.
Well, the story so far has been Baylor being able to move the ball, but unfortunately they've only cashed in with 3 points, and look at the time of possession.
Well, you take away the 84-yard touchdown run by Thomas, and they've got just 45 yards and 14 plays. And Baylor's had the ball, as you can see here in this graphic, almost the entire game.
Tim, something interesting in the fact that we saw Corey Pulley come in on just the second series of the game, as you look at Jeff Granger, number 10 on the sidelines. When or if Coach R.C. Slocum puts him in is maybe a topic of debate right now.
Well, that's right. I was getting a kick. Look at it. See the hat on backwards? That's Matt Miller, another quarterback. Looks like he's got the rally cap. Put it on backwards, trying to get a rally going here. Bullock's just 2 for 5, 36 yards.
That's Rodney Thomas on the carry. High stepping it out to the 43-yard line. Thomas, a very strong runner.
Does he have acceleration or what? You know, A&M has scored in 54 straight games now because of his touchdown, and one of only five schools to score 400 or more points in each of the last 2 years.
Rodney Thomas was playing in an all-star game in high school, heard about two kids that were sick in his hometown, and he gave away the watch and the chain that he received as part of the all-star game participation. That's the type of individual that he is. And Thomas gets the carry again and plows down over midfield and into Baylor territory before he's tackled by Scott Lewis.
I think R.C. Slocum and Bob Toledo, the offensive coordinators, had a talk with Thomas and Hill and the entire offensive team for A&M, because in this drive, those two carries just looks like there's more pep in their step.
R.C. Slocum spent 16 years as an assistant coach.
Oh, he's one of my favorite coaches in the country. Folks, he's going after a national title. These are two of my favorite coaches, Grant Taft and R.C. Slocum.
You talk about the relationship between them. It's very special. Two guys with a lot of tenure, as Thomas is tackled right at the 50-yard line.
It's not only time, though. It's quality. They're quality people. They're class individuals.
The tackle that time made by Lashay Mastin and Matthew Pearson on Rodney Thomas.
J.J. Joe taking a welcome rest.
Joe, pretty good student. 3.67 GPA.
Had a 3.9 last year. Slipping a little bit.
Oh.
No, he is intelligent.
Second down. 10 to go. Pulig dropping back to pass, and he throws a bounce pass down to the 35-yard line, trying to hit Brian Mitchell that time.
You know why? His old friend Albert Fontenot, the defensive end, was hanging on his leg. Almost took his leg off. That's why he threw a bounce pass. he couldn't push off his front leg because Fontenot was hanging on it.
You know, it's a credit to Coach Taft that he's been able to rebound with this team after losing so many quality players last year.
Watch this, though. Bam. He had a couple guys hanging on there. Looked like Pearson, 48, had a good shot at him, too.
Third down and 10. And they come out in a trips right formation. Rodney Thomas is the lone back. Spreading that defense a little bit. Pulling the out pattern to Wilbert Biggins, and he drops it.
You know, that's one Pulling would love to have back, too, because once again, the linebacker, this time Cravens, number 43, lost his man, and Biggins was wide open.
Biggins, 5'8", 184-pound sophomore that time. David Davis into punt. And Trooper Taylor is standing on his own 10-yard line.
You're on the defense now. You're saying, watch the fake. Watch the fake. Don't rough the kicker.
And Davis hangs it up high, which is one of his skills, but this time gets a bad bounce. And it comes all the way back to the 30-yard line.
Do you believe that?
They didn't gain much at all, a 20-yard punt. A&M, not in a hole. They have the ball.
This is right. This looks familiar. I remember this.
With Chevrolet's 24-hour roadside assistance, help is just a toll-free phone call away. Wherever you are, we'll be there. We'll even tell you where there is. What else would you expect from the heartbeat of America?
I'm a little lost.
America's future is taking shape in today's classrooms. Programs like Promise of Tomorrow, which encourage talented students associated with college football to pursue a teaching career, are helping to change America by changing education. A great teacher is a promise of tomorrow.
Hitachi is proud to sponsor the College Football Association. Hitachi's Promise of Tomorrow program gives teaching scholarships to all 67 CFA members.
The professors here at Baylor are very friendly.
The energy that the professors put into class is just outstanding.
They're really prepared for class.
Many of the professors I've taken simply because I've heard that they're such wonderful lecturers.
They've made learning fun. They've made it exciting. You want to go to class. You want to be a part of the discussion.
When you leave here, you will have the best possible education that you can have.
You know, in his 21 years at Baylor, Grant Taft has coached against 38 different Southwest Conference coaches. See a lot of guys come and go. Fumble on the play. And A&M may have recovered.
They say they did. I cannot believe how many fumbles we've seen out of Baylor today. That's three. They've lost two.
Robert Strait was the culprit that time for the Bears. And Taft can only shake his head.
Well, what he's going to do, when they go back and watch these films, they're going to say, you know, we pushed the fifth-ranked team in the country all over their own field, and we just handed it to them. Look at this. Once again, they're pounding it. The ball's loose already. Although it's tough to see from there. Take a look at Strait. There the ball comes out to the left side. They just stripped him before he hit.
And Patrick Bates was the man to pounce on it for the Aggies. Backs line up in the eye on first and 10. That's Doug Carter. What about 2 yards?
Once again, the defense called on to rally the troops. Again, Fontenot makes the tackle, and he does it with a lot of strength.
Has he been busy today or what?
Fontenot is sensational.
Second down, about 8 to go now for Texas A&M. They come in 6-0 overall and 2-0 in Southwest Conference play. Ranked number 5 in the country. And Corey Pulig, still the quarterback. This is Greg Hill, flag down. Thrown at the 34-yard line, might be holding against the Aggies.
Oh, I don't think there's any question about it. Again, they locked on. Looks like Dawson and Harrison both locked on their guys, and flag came into their area. Yeah, they'll move A&M back.
Matthew Pearson made the tackle that time. R.C. Slocum 2-0-1 in his career against Baylor. 1991 Southwest Conference Coach of the Year. Here's the call.
Hold it. Offense. Set it up.
You can see down at the bottom of the screen.
Well, there's Dawson at the top, though. Dawson had the jersey at the top of the screen.
Of course, holding one of those calls that is so discretionary.
You know, Fontenot, you say a busy day. He's got 11 tackles already today and a sack.
Put in for overtime. Wing left this time. Pulig on the waggle. Completes it to the 39-yard line and out of bounds. So they get back about six of those yards, complete to Greg Short, the tight end. An all-conference performer this year. Led the team coming into the ballgame with 13 receptions for 163 yards, tackled by Lachey Maston.
Still brings up third down and a very, very long way to go. This is a team, Baylor, that does not blitz. They don't blitz very often at all. As a matter of fact, they didn't have any against Houston. But each guy in the front four still had a sack last week, and three of the four blocked a pass. So they get a good push up front. They need it here.
Aggies coming out in their four wideout set. Out of the shotgun. Bullock has all kinds of room, and he's going to take off. Hooligan's down at the 18-yard line. He took a lick from Michael McFarland. It was a 21-yard pickup, but let's see what these flags are about.
It's going to be an illegal block, I believe, against A&M, but I'll tell you this. The linebacker, Broder, was out there covering in the flats, had his back to the runner. He could have made the stop a lot earlier. It is against A&M, but he never saw him coming. All right, now here comes the pressure. Hooligan now starts to run. Now, I want you to see number 61 for Baylor on the left hand of your screen, because Pulig will run right to him. Look, there he is, and finally he turns around and sees him and slaps him down.
He took a shot in the back that time too from McFarland.
Third down. Third down now.
It's going to be third down after that penalty. It was holding on the offense. The ball spotted just inside the 29-yard line.
All right, so it'll bring up third down, and Baylor gets another shot.
Flip backs. Pulik is going to pass over the middle. Incomplete intended for Ryan Matthews at the 3-yard line. Just overthrew him a touch.
You know, we just talked about Baylor not blitzing very much, and they came with the blitz that time.
So in comes Terry Venetulius to kick the field goal. He's 8 of 10 on the season. And Grant Taff is telling his team not to be offside. 75% in his career. He's 8 of 10, as I mentioned. This one coming from 45 yards out.
He led the Southwest Conference last year in scoring.
And this one's no good. Venetulius, usually very reliable. In fact, he's kicked two game-winning field goals this year. Misses from 45. Well, coming up on the Prudential Halftime Report, John Saunders with scores and highlights in our studios. And a feature on Garrison Hurst running for the Heisman. Marianne Grabovoy with a very nice story there. You might want to stick around for that.
Are you surprised at this game thus far?
You know what? When you look at the fact that Baylor has really matured since the second half of that Colorado game, maybe not. Maybe not. They really had an air of confidence about them coming into Kyle Field. A handoff to Robert Strait. He's out to the 32-yard line. Robert Strait, 260, a huge load.
I get a kick out of Buckley. He's out there having fun bouncing around. That time he just tackled the ball. His guy stood the runner up, so he grabbed Strait.
Some people will do anything to watch the game free, huh? J.J. Joe hangs on to it this time on the option. and is brought down right around the line of scrimmage. And an upset brewing at Chapel Hill.
What Natrode means is a load. He's much like Straight. Mac Brown's done a great job at Carolina. You know, this offense is inside-out offense. They read, pitch, end, and pass, and I think they still have to stretch that perimeter a little bit. They've got to put some pressure on the outside of A&M.
Brent Tapp would love nothing more than to get a win here today in his last appearance at Downfield.
J.J. Joe, 8 carries, -3 yards.
Connor in motion, quarterback draw, Joe. All kinds of yardage.
That was not a quarterback draw. He fumbled the football. That's survival of the fittest. But we'll take your kind assessment. Watch. Ball's loose. Now just pick it up and run. And look, everybody's gone.
Maybe they should put it in the playbook.
So J.J. Joe says, all right, I'm going for the first anyway. Move the chains, boys. 4 times they put the ball on the ground today.
Well, it's about time. One of the bounces went in their favor.
All right, correction. 5.
Can't even keep up with them. First down and 10. Spot left. The draw play. And they pick up good yardage. That's Kendrick Bell.
Oh, I want to tell you something. Old David Leach, the right guard, just sealed off the entire pursuit of the A&M defense. What a block he had. 6'4", 330 pounds. You know, at one point, Leach, number 69, was 367. Watch 69 here, right in the middle of your screen. Now watch what he does. He moves that whole line out of the picture. Look, he's still working. He's taking 2-3 guys and throwing them down, and it opens up the big hole. Grant says he's as good as any guard he's ever had. Well, not as he's ever had. He thinks he's as good as any guard in the country right now.
330 pounds. Red beans and rice didn't miss that guy.
Oh, yeah. I tell you what. You know, he's hand-spanked, corn-fed.
And the baby got back.
I beg your pardon?
He's very large. In the football vernacular. First down and 10 for the Bears, out of the eye. The pitch to Bell, trying to get to the corner, and Patrick Bates ran him into the Bates Motel. Good size on Patrick Bates, 225 pounds, 6'4". An All-American candidate, Tim?
Yeah, you know, he is, and he reminds me a lot of Steve Atwater, a linebacker playing safety. He's a transfer from UCLA, designated blitzer. Bob Davey, the defensive coordinator, calls him the Terminator. You can see why.
132 and counting to play in the first half. Baylor dominating statistically, but not on the scoreboard where it counts. Joe, play action. Bonner, complete. Touchdown, Baylor. What a catch. A 26-yard touchdown reception by Melvin Bonner on the play action, and Joe laid it right in the cradle.
All right, we told you now when you play option football, everybody has the assignment. We told you it's one-on-one coverage on the cornerback. Frazier and Bonner bumping and grinding all the way down. All right, here comes Bonner. 83. Right there, he's working on Hendricks, and all of a sudden, here comes Frazier over. Hendricks couldn't stop him. Bonner makes a sensational catch, touchdown.
And that was the 8th touchdown reception, tying a school record in a single season. Trey Weir with the extra point, and Baylor leads it 10-7. But you couldn't find a better thrown ball than that one by J.J. Joe.
And how about the catch?
Well, Bonner last week was double-teamed a lot. Only caught 2 balls for 13 yards, but he broke loose that time.
No, but he does get doubled a lot, and what that does, it frees up the rest of the attack. He's a hybrid tight end. You know that 6'3", 205 pounds?
You watch him run, and he's got that nice, long, lanky stride.
That's his 8th touchdown of the year. He leads the Southwest Conference. They call him an X-back, but man, they put him in I. They put him in motion. They overload him.
X marks the spot.
High school track athlete of the year.
Well, there's 1:17 remaining in the first quarter, and Melvin Bonner accepting the kudos on the sidelines. Good crowd on hand here at Kyle Field, over 70,000 on a sun-splash day. have had a wonderful time here during our visit. It was a great barbecue last night.
Tell you what, you put on the feed bag over at Tom's Barbecue. All they do is give you a knife. They don't give you a fork. Put that paper down and just lob everything right there on the table on top of the paper. Fantastic.
And adjust that belt when you're finished. No utensils necessary. Still some sparks coming from that table. Chilton to kick it off for Baylor. Back deep, Billy Mitchell and Ray Pickens for the Aggies. Kick caught at the 8-yard line by Mitchell. Spins out of a couple of tacklers' arms, but is gang tackled at 25. Tim Baylor leads it 10-7, but let's be honest here, it could be even worse for Texas A&M.
Yeah, but if you're an Aggie fan, as you look at the scoring drive, just keep this in mind. A&M has led or trailed in every game they've played this year at some point.
Dangerous pattern, though, or habit to be in, though, don't you think?
Oh, I don't think there's any question about it. What's really scary is they've trailed in the second half in four of their six games.
That last Baylor scoring drive, six plays, 71 yards, 2:26 on the dial before that Bonner Joe hookup. Rodney Thomas fumbles it, and Baylor has another Christmas present.
I'm not sure that's a Christmas present. That's good old-fashioned aggressive head-knocking football. Baylor's got one turnover. A&M's got two. But this place has really become quiet now. Watch Strahan right here, number 90 in white. White off the block. Come back to the strip the ball. See him rake it out of there. Ball is loose, and now everybody converges. Burleson, 42, gets there first.
Well, if there was ever a time that the Aggies needed their 12th man for a stand, this is it. And they come alive. The handoff is to John Henry, who powers it down to the 22-yard line.
Yeah, but as you look at that graphic, again, we tell you, in the fourth quarter, they outscore opponents 65-11, so don't count them out yet. Hey, aren't these fans great? This place is rocking.
Unbelievable. 71,000 strong. That's in the stat dive. Play action, and Sims now gets the handoff. Probably made it down to the 20-yard line, tackled by Sam Adams, last year's newcomer of the year in the conference on defense. And getting a little more consistency now, something that has the coaching staff happy for Texas A&M.
You know, this crowd is a little bit in shock, I believe, only because the game has been dominated so much by Baylor.
8 seconds to go, and they're going to try and get a playoff here. Have to be careful. Incomplete with one, and now time runs out.
You know what? There was a second left on that clock, and they didn't stop it fast enough. We'll see if they try to put it back on.
Now, let me ask you this, Tim. If you're Grant Taft, should you have called a timeout? We will address that question in just a second as we look at Taft pacing the sidelines. And the field goal unit has come back onto the field, so it looks like Baylor is going to get a chance to kick the field goal.
Well, I'm not sure yet. The officials are conferring, but they, in all fairness, should put a second back on the clock.
Well, we are at Kyle Field, after all.
No, see, they're going to call the half. Oh, I can't believe that.
RC says, let's go. First half is over.
Hey, I will tell you this. There was not only 1 second left on the clock. They've taken away one touchdown, straight got in, and they didn't give it to him. Now they're taking 1 second off the clock. That's three more points.
You don't think Grant Taft is hot?
He should be.
Any way you slice it, that's the end of the first half, whether you like it or not, Coach.
CFA College Football, this ABC Sports exclusive. Brought to you by Chevy Trucks, the trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last. And by Hitachi. Hitachi makes over 20,000 innovative products. We'll return with halftime activities after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Hey there, listen up. Education is money well spent. The refreshment is far more excellent. So fill me up with expectations.
I got what I want, no imitations. Just give me what the doctor ordered. Just what the doctor ordered. Dr. Pepper,
you want it?
Just what the doctor ordered. The taste of it, the water.
We love it.
I know everybody loves it.
Hitachi, they make, great shot. Now, what was I saying?
Hitachi makes camcorders and 20,000 other products worth celebrating. Hitachi.
Hitachi? They make, those old chips. They're in everything. They make things run.
Hitachi makes semiconductors and 20,000 other memorable products. Hitachi.
It takes strength to go climbing 7 days a week.
The sun upon my skin, right on. Hard against the wind, right on.
That's why one compact pickup powers you with the biggest full-size V6 engine you can get. Only Chevy S10 Tahoe 4x4. Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Might even be fun.
Fun?
Like a field trip.
Welcome to the island of Jeanti.
We're here to give your people a vaccine.
You like fettuccine with sun-dried tomatoes and a fresh basil pesto sauce? What are you doing tonight?
Me?
Where going to med school is stranger in paradise.
Did you know that in some villages way up north, it's kosher to have more than one wife?
Yeah, man.
The press calls it a rare treat.
I told them that you two knew the truth about Whitney Houston.
What?
Going to Extremes, Tuesday.
Today's engines are precise works of art that need protection for all the ways you drive. That's why you should insist on Exxon Superflow Motor Oil. It coats metal parts to reduce startup friction, prevents harmful sludge buildup from short trips, and protects from the heat of highway driving. For advanced engine protection, rely on the Tiger. Exxon Superflow. For all the ways you drive.
The styling of the Infiniti Q45 has a beauty that increases as time passes. The interior offers a lasting pleasure, an enduring luxury, which is important because when it comes to a luxury car, as well as most other things in life, infatuation is easy. True love is what takes a little time.
Mel Gibson stars tonight at 10:30 here on 13.
Well, we're back, and at halftime, it's 10-7 for Baylor over Texas A&M, and we tried to catch up with Coach Brent Taft. We couldn't get him, but R.C. Slocum had this to say about that controversial last-second play to end the half.
Well, I don't know. I think perhaps that Grant thought that he had more time left on the clock, and the clock had run out, and I was just concerned that... With the referee over a meeting with our coaching staff, I felt like A&M ought to have some representation there.
It did look like there was 1 second left on the clock. Now, the performance of your team, you had the 184-yard run, but they've shut you down pretty much. Are you surprised at this
at
all?
No, I think they're doing a good job. They've made a lot of plays. They're doing a good job both sides of the ball, and we just need to come back and make some plays. We've hurt ourselves a bunch in this ballgame.
All right, R.C., thank you. And, Tim, here's a look at that play. Look at the clock right there, 2 seconds even. There's no question they should have put time back on the clock there, at least giving them the opportunity to the field goal. But my question is, why Grant Taft didn't use his last timeout to go ahead and go after the field goal? And the other situation that was controversial was Strait obviously scored a touchdown earlier, and they said his knee touched at the one. Baylor didn't get the touchdown there. They only lead by three.
Well, Coach Grant Taft has to feel good in one respect going into the locker room, proving to his team if nothing else psychologically, they can compete with Texas A&M. They moved the ball very well, but only have 10 points to show for it. It's going to be a very interesting second half of play. Right now, back to New York and John Sons.
From ABC Sports, the Prudential Halftime Report. Brought to you by Prudential. When it comes to insurance, real estate, and investments, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the rock. The Prudential. Rock solid. From New York, John Saunders.
And we welcome those of you who are watching Baylor and Texas A&M, Washington State and USC, and Michigan State and Ohio State. It is time now for the Prudential Halftime Report as we run down the scores and highlights We start off with one of the number one teams in the nation, Miami, facing Virginia Tech. This in the Big East. Trey Cole checking everyone off. Miami's Darren Smith hits Cole behind the line of scrimmage. Causes the incompletion. Miami's defense all over Virginia Tech today. Once again into the backfield. Meanwhile, Gino Toretta, though, would have his own way. 15-yard touchdown pass to Lamar Thomas here, who makes a terrific catch, 17-0. Stephen McGuire scored his 33rd career touchdown, most ever by a Miami player. Toretta, 17 of 28, 249. Meanwhile, Washington, they're also number one. Leading Pacific easily 14-0. Napoleon Kaufman has an 8-yard touchdown run. Mark Brunell, 3-yard touchdown run. Michigan clobbers Minnesota in the Little Brown Judge 83rd meeting, 63-13. Derek Alexander, 4 touchdown receptions. That's a school record. And Michigan joins the 1,000 club. They play that game. Syracuse will get there next week. And they have 728 wins, most in Division I, 8 national titles. Alabama, number 4 and undefeated, facing Ole Miss. 31-10 on the clobbering here. Jay Barker had a good day, had the pat on the elbow. He injured that last week. Second quarter, Barker to David Palmer in the end zone. 22 yards. Palmer's first touchdown catch of the year, 7-0. Derek Elassick is the star running back, also hobbled by injuries, but the good second effort from 2 yards out gets it in, 14-0. Elassick's streak of 100 yards continues, and meanwhile, Barker, 25 of 39 for 285 yards, that a career high. Texas A&M and the Baylor Bears, a game some of you are watching here, 10-7 is the score there. Rodney Thomas, 84 yards when he breaks through, a nice fake in the backfield as well. Wide open to the end zone for the touchdown as Texas A&M starts to roll. Then Baylor stopped for the second time today on fourth and goal. They can't punch this one in. Grant Taft tossing his headgear. Ronnie Thomas, 84 yards, doing most of the damage as Texas A&M, though, is down now 10-7 at halftime. Nebraska and Missouri, Tommy Frazier, 2 touchdowns. Brian Bennett, 2 field goals. Kansas State and Colorado, 33-7 in the fourth quarter. Cordell Stewart, 9-yard touchdown run there. Notre Dame and BYU, no contest, 42-16 the final there, as Rick Meyer had a 54-yard touchdown pass. USC, another one of the games you've been watching, 21-7 over Washington State right now. Drew Bledsoe has a 1-yard touchdown run. Penn State and West Virginia, this one also on your ABC stations. The Mountaineers hoping to become the third straight Big East team to knock off Penn State. Kerry Collins, first start, but it's Richie Anderson on the 14-yard touchdown run to punch this one through. Jake Kelcher, though, for West Virginia, finds Jay Kearney 74 yards when this one is hauled in, and as a couple of defenders fall down, gets it to the end zone for the touchdown as West Virginia and everyone falling over. Kerry Collins with a 67-yard touchdown pass to Troy Drayden. 19-16 is that score in the second quarter. Oregon State and Stanford, 14-7. Ellery Roberts, a short touchdown run, made it 14-0. They're coming back as Oregon State. North Carolina and Georgia Tech, 10-0. North Carolina with the lead on 4th-and-7. They fake the field goal. And Bose hits Falkerson, 23 yards. First and goal at the 3, and 2 plays later, you knew it would be Natroni Means. 1 yard, bangs this one in once again as North Carolina gets in front. He does get it across. William Bell has a 1-yard touchdown catch, though. It's 17-7 is that score now. Kansas, ranked number 22, Maurice Douglas, 13-yard touchdown run for the Jayhawks. They lead Oklahoma 27-10. Arkansas State and Mississippi State. Greg Plum, 48-yard touchdown run. Touchdown pass, rather, to Willie Harris, 14-0. It's now 42-6. Jackie Sherrill against Ray Perkins, the coaches of these two teams, well, they were teammates on the 1965 national champions out of Alabama. Ohio State and Michigan State. John Cooper has been under a lot of heat lately. The Buckeye faithful calling for his head, and they're struggling again as Brett Johnson connects with Mill Coleman. 26 yards as he runs out of trouble. Johnson making the start today. Coleman with a terrific catch. He later connected with him once again, fired up with a start as the Ohio State Buckeyes are trying to come back here. The touchdown run gets it to the corner of the end zone. 17-14, Ohio State has that lead. Butler by Noti, 15 yards. That was that touchdown run. Houston and Texas, this has been a wild one back and forth. Peter Gardere had two touchdown passes and a run to make it 28-0. But Klingler with his fifth touchdown pass, and you see what the score is right now. Meanwhile, congratulations to Chris Basilian of Illinois Wesleyan playing Carthage today. They lead this one 63-0. He has four touchdown receptions to break Jerry Rice's all-time record, now with 52 touchdowns for Chris Basilian. We'll continue with the Prudential Halftime Report in just a moment, but first, a look at some more scores from around the nation.
The garden and read my books. The dreams were dreamt and memories made. The children grew up and I grew old. A house where I belong.
When the Prudential created the Living Needs Benefit, we made it possible for the terminally ill to collect their death benefit while they're alive. So if they choose, they can afford to live out their days not in the confines of a hospital, but in the comfort of their own home.
There's a house where I belong.
For information, call 1-800-THE-ROCK.
At Texas A&M University, we're proud of our traditions, the old and the new. At Texas A&M, excellence is our greatest tradition.
Welcome back once again to New York. I'm John Saunders with the Prudential Halftime Report. Let's continue now with a look at some scores and highlights. We'll start things with Syracuse and Temple in the Big East. No contest here. Marvin Graves only had to play one half. Syracuse had five interceptions, and Temple only had 51 yards rushing. Clemson and NC State, this in the ACC. Tigers looking to make it four straight wins over the Wolfpack. A defensive struggle tied at six with about 10 minutes to go in the fourth quarter, when Terry Jordan hits Reggie Lawrence with a four-yard touchdown to put them up 13-6. Ken Hatfield trying to get his squad pumped up. Then with 5:44 to go, Clemson freshman backup quarterback Patrick Sapp is chased by Battle and Akins. The fumble is recovered by Damian Covington in the end zone for the touchdown. And 20-6 is the final. NC State, as Anthony Barber had 21 carries, 140 yards for NC State. Clemson lost four fumbles. Florida all over Louisville, 31-17. Shane Matthews with two touchdown passes in the first half. He finished with three and 317 yards, 32 of 46 in attempts. Virginia, ranked number 24, beats up William & Mary, 33-7. Gerard Washington over 100 yards rushing and two touchdowns for Virginia. Wisconsin and Indiana, this in the Big Ten. Indiana quarterback Trent Green calling for help today. The Wisconsin Badgers defense sacked the senior five times in the afternoon, but in the fourth quarter, he comes back. Thomas Lewis, 35 yards on this touchdown, gives the Hoosiers the lead by seven. Wisconsin with an opportunity, though. A minute left to tie the game, but Darrell Bevel overthrows Michael Rohn on a fourth and goal from the two-yard line, and the Indiana Hoosiers win 10-3. Michael Batts, 23 carries, 111 yards in his first start for Indiana. Those are the games that are done. And look at some games that will be underway tonight, including Arizona. They've creeped into the top 25. Boston College still undefeated. And, of course, Georgia, now number 7, 6-1. That game will feature Garrison Hurst, the Heisman Trophy candidate. He leads the nation in touchdowns. And as our Marianne Grabovoy tells us, The end zone is not the only zone Garrison Hurst has found.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this.
I feel different on any play that I can score. I should make a big run. I mean, when I'm running upfield, if this one guy's in front of me, I'm not thinking about him. I know I'm going to get by him. I'm thinking about the next guy who's going to try and tackle me. It's just something. It's just a certain feeling I have when I have a few big plays in the game.
For Georgia's junior tailback, Garrison Hurst, being in the zone now means being in the Heisman Trophy race.
It's one of my goals to win the Heisman, so I mean, if I don't win it this year, I'll definitely be back here next year to win it.
This year, he leads the nation in scoring and is second in rushing, averaging 151.6 yards per game, just behind San Diego State's Marshall Faulk.
He's got great vision, and he's got great quickness, and he's able to go side to side or either forward. He can run over you, or he can make you miss him. And I think one thing that he's got that Herschel didn't was a good quickness as far as side to side.
Herschel, of course, is Herschel Walker, Georgia's last Heisman Trophy winner a decade ago. After seven games, Hurst numbers are ahead of the numbers posted by Herschel in his Heisman season. And with Georgia taking more to the air, Hurst has averaged under 19 carries a game.
He's going to be a good pro prospect. One thing that he's got is, you know, he's got that quickness. He hit the line very well. They run the ball so hard. They're big bites that can got a lot of speed.
Herschel Walker's 1982 Heisman Trophy here at the University of Georgia is a constant reminder of just whose records Garrison Hurst is chasing. He says his goal at one time was merely to have his name mentioned in the same sentence with the Heisman Trophy. Now that he's a serious candidate, he says the lure of this bronze statue is proving to be a powerful incentive for him to play even harder. But all the publicity that goes with it, well, it's a bit of a heady experience.
Break it down.
I never thought it would happen this soon. I thought maybe next year it would. My coach told me on that plane flight last year after the bowl game that, you know, next year would be my year. I never thought that it would be like this, though.
Gerard Garrison Hurst grew up in a small Georgia town near the South Carolina border, Lincolnton, Georgia, where there are just 1,400 people, all of them crazy about football and the thought of a local guy bringing home the Heisman.
I mean, that trophy would not just be for me, it would be for the whole town.
Do you think that you deserve the Heisman Trophy?
I think by the end of the season, and hopefully after having a few other great games, you know, I will deserve it.
You're digging in.
I'm definitely digging in.
You can't touch this.
Yeah, Marshall Faulk may be the leading candidate right now, but with Garrison Hurst playing in the SEC, my personal vote would go for Garrison Hurst for this year's Heisman Trophy, at least right now. A reminder, coming up next week, three games of regional coverage. The number one Washington Huskies take on number 16 Stanford in the Pac-10. Garrison Hurst of Georgia faces Florida and Shane Matthews. Or in the Big Ten, it's the Ohio State Buckeyes and the Iowa Hawkeyes. Check your local listings. We'll have more on the Prudential Halftime Report in just a moment.
Changes, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the Prudential, rock solid in securities, insurance, and real estate.
Racing fans, how do you pick winners?
You bet on your favorite jockeys, you bet on your favorite colors.
I go by the horses that have won the most.
Probably just pick the favorites.
Go by hunches and lucky numbers.
Play Breeders' Cup Pick 7. Pick the winners of all seven Breeders' Cup races being run on October 31st, and you could win millions.
I think Pick 7 is great, and I hope I win it.
So look for a Breeders' Cup simulcast outlet in your area and play Pick 7.
Tonight we focus on opportunity and achievement and the student-athlete.
The NCAA, which is composed of over 900 member institutions, makes rules and regulations to protect the interests of student-athletes and the integrity of athletic competition. The NCAA is presidents, faculty members, athletic directors, and coaches at hundreds of campuses across the country. We are the NCAA.
Welcome back. We'll get you back out to the game in just a moment. But first, a reminder, once again on New Year's Day, ABC will televise the Tournament of Roses parade as well as the Rose Bowl game. So it's time once again for another Rose Bowl moment. On Tuesday, the committee named its 75th Rose Bowl queen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the queen of the 104th Tournament of Roses, Liana Carissa Yamasaki.
The winner will reign over this year's Rose Bowl and Tournament of Roses parade. That's it for the Prudential Halftime Report. Right now, let's take you back out to your game.
From ABC Sports, the Prudential Halftime Report has been brought to you by Prudential. When it comes to insurance, real estate, and investments, there is one certainty: the financial strength of the rock. The Prudential, rock solid.
Halftime at Kyle Field, 10-7, Baylor leads A&M. Back with the third quarter kickoff in a minute.
A driver's side airbag, a moonroof, a rear spoiler, anti-lock brakes, a Bose music system, and leather interior. Now, who's the fairest of them all?
Hey, use a spark plug that's tested the fire clean for 30,000 miles. Motorcraft. Motorcraft quality parts. From Ford.
There is a sound you can hear above the music. The sound of German being spoken by those whose passion is to live life. In your town, America, and the world, Beck's, the number one imported German beer.
Visa salutes American Olympic champions. The year was 1976. Matt Wilkins puts away the competition with his second round throw.
Let's see if he lives up to his nickname, the plate great.
As part of their continued support of amateur athletics, Visa is proud to donate another $1,000 to the U.S. Olympic team to support future Olympic hopefuls in their quest for the gold.
There's a tropical island that's not on any map, though it's easy to find. It's warmed by the sun and caressed by the winds, with its own hidden treasures, local delicacies, and exotic festivals. But this island moves. It's a Carnival cruise ship. So if you go, get there on time and get out your Visa card. Because the world's most popular cruise line doesn't stay in one place for long, and it doesn't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Well, Baylor is threatening to spoil Texas A&M's perfect 6-0 record overall in their number 5 ranking in the country. We are ready for the kick at the start of the third quarter. And the Aggies will settle for it on their own 20-yard line. CFA College Football, this is ABC Sports Exclusive, is brought to you by American Honda, who has been making quality cars in America the past 10 years. And for reliable, on-time delivery throughout Europe and around the world, you can trust UPS. Well, Corey Pulick is still the quarterback. He came in after the first series for Jeff Granger.
Granger was 0-for-1. Pulick just 3-for-9, 41 yards. That's it. Neither one has really been outstanding here today.
That's Greg Sharp in motion. The toss goes to Greg Hill, and Hill is stacked up behind the line of scrimmage, 19-yard line. Nice play that time by Michael McFarland, safety. Statistically, Tim, it was all Baylor.
Well, it really was. I mean, you look at the plays they ran compared to A&M's. You look at the rushing yardage is about the same, but then the passing yardage has been Baylor, which surprises everybody. And time of possession heavily in favor of the Bears.
Greg Hill, after that carry, is now 5 carries on the afternoon for just 14 yards, far below his season average. Pulling the pass, quick three-step drop, and it's dropped by Tony Harrison. Catchable ball.
You know, we talk about the statistics, and yet Baylor really had a lot of missed opportunities in that first half. As a matter of fact, not only did the clock run out on them when they thought they had more time, but look at this. They had first and goal twice. They forced two turnovers, came away with 0 points. A&M had a 98-yard scoring drive.
Most of it coming on that Thomas run.
So Baylor sure has had its chances.
Bullock on the screen pass underthrows Greg Hill, and he went down hard at the 5-yard line. 1-2-3 punt for the Aggies. Baylor Bears will get good field position.
Great pressure by Matthew Pearson, too. I mean to tell you, he drilled Pulick, and the next time Pulick drops back to pass, he's going to be thinking about that hit.
As we look at Slocum, will it be Pulick dropping back to pass? Do you come back with Granger? I mean, Pulick really hasn't moved the team that well.
Well, R.C. told us yesterday he'll do that on feeling, how he thinks the quarterback will do, and right now he still thinks Pulick's the guy.
Trooper Taylor back deep on his own 30. Davis gets a nice punt off all the way back to the 25. That's Jackson. And Jackson takes out to the 35. Nice punt. 55 yards and a 10-yard return. Just want to tell you again, CFA College Football is an ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by American Honda, who has been making quality cars in America past 10 years. And for reliable on-time delivery throughout Europe and around the world, you can trust UPS. First down and 10 from the 35-yard line. J.J. Joe almost bobbled the snap again, Tim. Fell forward for about 2.5 yards, tackled by Larry Jackson. Really having some problems, it looks like, on that exchange.
Look at J.J. for some reason today. The battery, the center, and the quarterback having a tough time getting the things together. You know, Joe was a fourth-team quarterback on the roster, headed for the scout squad in 1979. And light went on. All of a sudden, he understood what he was doing. He improved. Gable got hurt. Steve Needham floundered. J.J. became the guy.
And speaking of quarterbacks, Granger quickly coming back in, warming up on the sidelines. That's Mims on the carry. His knee touched down at the 41-yard line, tackled by the cornerback, Derek Frazier. Offensively in the first half, J.J. Joe, 4 of 8, 109 yards, 1 touchdown. Mims and Joe ran the ball fairly well, and Melvin Bonner, of course, with one big reception for a touchdown. Defensively, Marcus Buckley led for Texas A&M with 9 tackles. Third down, 4 to go. Play action has a man wide open. That's Melvin Bonner with a first down at the 50-yard line. J.J. Joe pulls the trigger and finds his main man.
Locked on Frazier again, 23. You get that man coverage. You better come up, not play soft. Lock on him and fight him down that first 5 yards. J.J. Joe, you know, his name really is John Joe. That's how the J.J. came about. His friends just started calling him J.J. and it stuck. Now it's J.J. Joe.
Sounds better that way. Number 4 in school history in all-purpose yardage coming into this contest. Drops back to pass, has a man open. That's Reggie Miller, and a nice reception complete at the 42-yard line, working on quarterback Aaron Glenn that time.
They locked on the other side to the other corner. Coaches like Glenn, too. They say he has to be an all-conference quarterback. He plays so well. He's got 3 picks this year. But again, you're going to be one-on-one. You better get up and knock him the first 5 yards, stay in his hip pocket. See, he's giving him too much ground. You cannot play that soft one-on-one.
Handoff is to Robert Straight this time. Over the 40, down to the 38-yard line.
That's enough for the first down, right. You know, we were talking about J.J. Joe. I want to stay on that subject for a second because I think it's really interesting. And, you know, Grant Taft is a coach I have a lot of respect for, but he was not impressed with Joe in high school. Did not even offer him a scholarship. Offensive line coach Bill Lane says, wait a minute, coach. He goes, no, I don't. Called him on his own and offered him a scholarship without Grant knowing it. Grant Taft's glad he got here.
That's how assistant coaches lose jobs sometimes if things don't work out. Mims on the carry.
Or get a raise if they do.
I'd be bucking for the raise right now. Tackle that time by Michael Hendricks on Mims. It's interesting that you talk about Joe that way because Bob Davey, the coordinator for A&M, watched J.J. Joe play high school football and has followed his career since about the 10th grade.
Yeah, he was recruiting him to come to school here at Texas A&M. Right now, Joe's just so comfortable with this offense. Looks good.
Back
right side of the eye. J.J. to work again. Far sideline to Miller, complete. Dodges one man and is out of bounds at the 12-yard line. The Bears marching on. Again, it's Frazier, one-on-one. Got a little bit close, over-aggressive. You've got to do that. But this time, I think that Miller felt it. Gave the little Art Monk swing move back to the inside, and he just flew by him. Now watch this. All right, one-on-one coverage. They've been picking on the corner. You come up a little bit harder now. You play in his hip pocket. This is what happens. He makes the catch. Now watch him swing on it. Boom. He's by him, and he picks up extra yardage.
Tim, could this set up the out-and-up pattern, too?
Well, I think that's basically what happened that time. But I don't think they like to go to that out-and-up too much.
Backside of the eye, Bonner, slot right. Joe, draw play. That was Kendrick Bell that time. Makes it down to the 9-yard line, but Baylor moving the ball well here early in the third quarter of play. The tackle that time made by Larry Jackson.
Let me take that another step. The reason they don't like to go to the out and up is because it takes a lot of time to develop. And against a team like A&M, you don't want a long developing play because they are so aggressive, so strong, get to the quarterback so quickly. You want a fake, boom, quick release, and fire it.
Well, we haven't seen Texas A&M get a lot of sacks so far this afternoon. Quick drop, fade pattern to Bonner. Catches it, but out of bounds.
Look at Frazier talking to him. Frazier walking up, pointing to him. Finally got him. Frazier actually forced him out of bounds is what he did, which is legal.
Almost using that sideline, Tim, as an extra man.
All right, play him hard. All right, come up on him. See, we talked about that. That's what he's doing. Now you get in his hip pocket. You just keep riding him inside out, inside out. Well, I don't know if that's pass interference. Pushed him.
Little contact going on there.
See, you can use your body to run him out of bounds, but you can't push him. He pushed him. No call.
Third down and 9. Baylor has struggled inside the 20 this afternoon. Going blitz. And they come on the quarterback draw. Joe lunges forward to the 8-yard line. And under heavy pressure, he goes down. Lance Teichman and Larry Jackson made the tackle.
So Trey Weir will come back on. But he already hit a big field goal earlier.
Again, though, they stall.
Joe almost got out of this. Watch this. Here comes the pressure. Boom. One leg. They just got him by one leg and pulled it out from under.
25-yard field goal by Trey Weir. Made one earlier today from 39. And this one splits the uprights. The Bears increase their lead to 13-7. Trouble brewing at Kyle Field for the Aggies. We're going to take a break and come right back.
It seems Europeans have a passion for certain things, American. And one of them happens to be the reliable, efficient delivery of a certain American delivery company, UPS. Fact is, we've built the most comprehensive delivery network in Europe. So next time you need something shipped there, use the outfit Europeans find. Well, so fashionable. UPS. We run the tightest ship in Europe.
In a moment of inspiration, Rockport combined the lightweight comfort of its walking shoe with the rugged performance of its hiking boot. The Discovery Series by Rockport. Do not try this at home. Rockport, you should be in our shoes.
Hitachi?
Wait, I know. Remnick.
Look, your favorite show.
Oh.
Hitachi makes big screen TVs and 20,000 other entertaining products. Hitachi.
This is the new Civic Coupe from Honda. Maybe you'd like to take a second look.
For 2 years, they've dominated the conference. Now the Bills are battling for their division lead. They tackle the Jets live on ABC's Monday Night Football.
Back at Kyle Field in College Station, Texas, the number 5-ranked Aggies trail the Baylor Bears right now, 13-7. And that man there
Brad Taft, the coach of Baylor, you talk about being able to motivate his players. He once ate a worm, Tim, to get his team ready for a game against Texas without barbecue sauce, too.
Whatever it takes. You know, Baylor won only 3 games in 3 years prior to Grant Taft taking over there. He's been the Southwest Conference Coach of the Year 6 times since.
Tremendous teacher of the game. Mike Chilton with the kick. Not that deep. Lands at the 9-yard line. Ray Mickens cutting back. He's got a seam. Mickens turns it upfield and steps out of bounds at the 37-yard line. And he's juiced up. Keith Caldwell pushed him out of bounds with a nice 29-yard return.
Fans here at Kyle Stadium are hoping this will really turn the tide. Granger's going to come back out and be the quarterback, so they think things are changing. But look at this return. He tries to take it up the middle, and then everybody leaves their lanes. See, you got to stay in your lanes when you cover kickoffs. They didn't. He got outside. Big return.
Well, against Stanford, he sat out a couple of series, came in, won the game. Granger gets a chance to do it again. Hands it off to Greg Hill. And Hill is out to the 45-yard line, a pickup of 7. Let's go back to New York for an update on Texas-Houston with John Saunders. John?
Mark, Houston and Texas, it was a wild affair. Jimmy Klingler here, though, is picked up by Norman Watkins with just over 4 minutes left. He takes it in for the touchdown, and it's 45-38 final. Mark.
All right, John, if there was ever a pass that Klingler would want to take back, that would be the one. Two tight ends in now. Second down. Play action. Granger on the waggle. Hits his tight end at the 45-yard line. James McKeon with a reception.
See, now there's no reason for that. Granger set the play up nicely. Little play action. Rolled. And had his receiver wide open. McKeon. And instead he throws him a low pass. He has to get out of his knees. He gets back to the line of scrimmage. There's no reason for that. He could have had the first easily. All he had to do was just lob it out there.
Oh, it's interesting.
Almost shuffle it.
Yeah, they've fiddled with his mechanics so much this year. It's got to take an effect on him somehow. Two wide receivers split wide. Granger goes back to pass under pressure. Steps up and runs it. A shoestring tackle at the 43-yard line, but Granger picks up 15 yards. First down, Aggies. Vaughn knows the man that made the tackle, but what made that play go is they came on the blitz. Baylor doesn't come very often on the blitz, but they did this time. And this is the escapability of this guy, Granger. Watch this. There's Fontenot. Here comes Granger. Step up. Now watch. The chase begins. And there's a difference in size between those guys. One's 193 pounds. One's 243. And yet Fontenot still tracks him down. Big play, though, for Granger. He's done that so many times this year.
Greg Hill. Touchdown. Explosive, you bet. Two tight ends. Watch this. They shut off that side, walling off. Oh, what a block by 68 Dawson. Just push everybody back. The rest is Hill. In, out, spin, turn, drive, touchdown. Greg, thrill, Hill. It's Greg Hill time.
GHT. And on GHT, it's 14-13. The Aggies seize the lead back from Baylor. And this is the game taping up. Come on back.
Introducing the 190 horsepower Prelude VTEC. It's very quick. No matter how you look at it.
We put our best people on the project. Hope they come through.
One network color laser printer not only brings everyone together, it brings out the best in everyone. Intelligent color for any document, only from Xerox.
Putting it together. Before building new water mains, we had to know where the old ones were.
Xerox color not only helps with little details, it gives you the big picture, too. Intelligent color for any document, only from Xerox.
Putting it together.
Nothing you've ever seen.
I am Dracula.
Nothing you've ever experienced. Nothing you've ever imagined.
Yes,
can prepare you for what's coming. Stoker's Dracula, Francis Ford Coppola film, rated R, at theaters Friday the 13th of November.
Bob Toledo congratulating Hill on his touchdown. He now has 7 carries, 61 yards, and there's Mrs. Hill. You see the button she's wearing, number 27. My son is 27. He's also big time. What a player.
He's a football player.
GHT.
It's Greg Hill time, everybody.
The Mad Hatter. Try that on for size.
Terry Venetulius with the kickoff. This one will be into the end zone about 4 yards deep and touchback time for the Bears.
You know, the toughest thing as you look at Hill, the toughest thing for the visiting team is when you fall behind to generate that same enthusiasm you had when you were leading. I mean, look at the confidence these guys have now.
Greg Hill saying all day long, baby. All day long.
See, his mom won't like that. She likes him to be humble.
Hey, he got in trouble the last time.
You got to be able to let it out once in a while.
And talent, he deserved it on that play.
Talent without ego ain't talent.
Bradford and Jackson in the backfield for Baylor. Joe, on the pitch that time, Randall Jackson from nearby Brenham High School. And he's tackled by Marcus Buckley and Reggie Graham.
Here's Buckley. Inside out, inside out. You got to stay out. Now, he knows he doesn't have the pitch, man. He had the quarterback, but he still releases as soon as the ball is pitched. Great pursuit. He gets there and makes the stop. Southwest Compton sack leader. Terrific play. Buckley's final.
Second and 6, backs out of the eye. The handoff is to the fullback that time, Bradford Lewis. And he's over the 25, out to the 27-yard line, tackled by Jesse Cox that time. Well, we talked about it earlier, how A&M trailed most of the first halves in the season collectively. They have come back to take away the lead here with 6:50 remaining in the third quarter.
Well, you get that confidence. You know, when you... A&M has won the Southwest Conference title 5 times in 8 years. That'll make you confident.
Taylor lines up in the stack guy on 3rd and 4. They hand it up to the deep back and a first down by Brandel Jackson. Tackled again by Jesse Cox. Jackson getting used to the lack of playing time after being a star in high school like so many freshmen around the country.
Mark Baylor runs that fear attack again with several formations, which makes it very difficult to defend. They go to that eye split, the eye back, the one back. You can't read it. The option pass then turns into a defensive mistake, into a touchdown. We've already seen that today, but they've been using this offense very, very effectively.
Joe to Bonner, and he drops him. Boy, he was making this move before he caught the ball. That's what he did. Hit him right in the hands.
He knows it. Watch this. See, he's got Frazier beaten. Frazier comes up again on the run. This is what the coaches were telling the corners. Forget the run. You're out there to cover. I don't care what happens. Frazier came up on the run, and he was wide open, and Bonner just dropped it.
Ball on the 32, 2nd and 10. Getting the ball out and ready to swing it. Teichelman with the tackle.
Talking with the coaches before the game, they said first down is so very important in our offense. We need 2nd and 5, 2nd and 4, 2nd and 6 in that area, which gives us a lot of options to go to on 2nd down. Once he drops that pass on 1st down, now it's still 2nd and 10. You don't have a lot of options. It changes everything. Makes the defense more aggressive. put Baylor in a world of hurt right here. Well, the ears are pinned back. And here comes the 12th man. Again, they run the pass back against the grain, and it's complete out of the 40, but short of a first down. McKenzie made the reception. He's tackled by Jesse Cox.
Very well-designed play. We saw it go big earlier in the game. McKenzie, again, ran it very well, but they didn't have it up to the first. See, that's the torque you get on defense. Once you hold that first down play, then you're loaded up. You've got the leverage the rest of the way.
Brett Delaney to punt, standing on his own 26-yard line. Gets off a high one that'll bounce at the 26 and keep going. And it's down at the 15. A&M seizing back some of the momentum. We'll be right back.
When you don't have to send your package overnight, you can save yourself a bundle.
What a difference a day makes.
Two-day priority mail service.
24 little hours.
From your post office. Send up to £2 in just 2 days, for just $2.90. That's right. That's some difference.
What a difference a day makes. We deliver for you.
Autumn at McDonald's, where our new oven-baked apple pies are ready with their golden, delicious apple filling. Buy one now, and your local McDonald's will donate 25 cents to Ronald McDonald Children's Charities. It'll warm your heart.
The temperature never drops below Xerox. That's very important to remember, especially at a time like this, when it's very deserted and very cold. Ah, you did remember Xerox antifreeze. The temperature never drops below Xerox.
Presenting the new Civic Del Sol from Honda. It's a sporty open-top car with a very remarkable feature. When it's windy outside, it's not so windy inside.
Well, two big runs and two big touchdowns for Texas A&M. The first one came on Rodney Thomas's 84-yard touchdown run, and then Baylor countered with a 39-yard field goal by Trey Weir to make it 7-3 in the second quarter, and then Melvin Bonner put the Bears up 10-7 after a beautiful 26-yard touchdown catch. Trey Weir made it 13-7 in the third quarter after a field goal, and then it was Greg Hill time, making it 14-13 on a 40-yard scamper into the end zone. Greg Hill, really one of those money backs. Two tight ends in. First and 10. The handoff is to Hill. Falls over the 16 out to the 17-yard line, where he's tackled by Sean Cravens, the middle linebacker. Touch 86 short. You think he's holding? Hey, we got to tell him that he's on offense. He can't do that. He can't make those tackles.
Oh, boy.
Miller's still got the rally cap there, 13. Second down and 9 after the gain of 1. And flags down.
You know, you saw Miller with his hat on backwards. He's one of the quarterbacks, one of the young quarterbacks. He's one of only two players on the roster not from Texas.
An abundance of talent in this state.
They call him a foreigner.
Well, this is another country, isn't it, Texas?
Full start. Offense. Second half.
How about
you said
this?
It.
Look at this. Of course, there's Miller. He's from San Diego. He's the one from California.
There's nowhere to surf in Texas, is there?
There's a place to ski.
Second down. Granger looking downfield, and he is almost picked off. Two Baylor defenders. Each one over the ball, neither of them came up with it. It was Lewis and Caldwell.
This is a nightmare for a coach. Look at Grant Tapp out on the field. It's a nightmare. It's an easy pick for one of them, and not only did they not get the ball, but they hurt each other. Now watch this.
He throws, and then here comes Caldwell, number three. Boom! Lewis and Caldwell just smack right into each other. They not only don't get the pick, they get shaken up. There's a motto in there somewhere. Third and 14. Trips right. Granger back to pass. Scrambles now. To the 27-yard line, and depending on the spot, he might have the first down.
Where are you playing?
A&M. First down. He was pushed out of bounds there by Rainer Finley.
I'll tell you what, he may not get it the way R.C. Slocum was looking at it. See, to me, well, you know what? That's a good call. His knee hit right down at the 25-yard line.
And we have a player down at the 3-yard line for Texas A&M.
See, I thought normally when a guy runs like that, you're playing at home, crowds behind you, you have that little extra oomph, you get that little stretch. I thought he had it.
Looks like he got a good spot from the officials, though.
Okay. He got it.
Jason Matthews is the injured player. He's the starting right tackle. Well, tomorrow it's an international figure skating spectacular. Olympic medalist Nancy Kerrigan, top American Todd Eldridge, and the dynamic Kala Urbanski and Rocky Marvel compete against some of the world's hottest young stars. Sudafed Skate America International begins tomorrow at 4 Eastern, 3 Pacific on ABC Sports.
He got a very, very good mark there from the official because his knee did hit at the 25. You know, I picked Texas A&M at the beginning of the year for the national championship because in this day and age in college football, the schedule, really, if it's conducive to winning the national championship, oftentimes dictates who it is. And consequently, and that's why we've had the split national champions the last couple of years, their schedule certainly is conducive for it, and this is one of the final hurdles that they have to take right here toward that national championship.
A&M with Cotton on their collective minds.
Granger only 1 for 3 passing, 0 yards. You see his rushing numbers.
Play action. Setting up the screen pass to Greg Hill, and he is jacked at the 22-yard line by Sean Cravens. Hey, Greg, how do you like that? Wow, did he get hit? Tough guy, though, gets right back up.
Cravens, the transfer, he's a senior, 5'10", 219 pounds, comes with bad intentions. People wanted a penalty here because he ripped his helmet off, but this is a good play. Look, he fights through the blocks, comes over, tucks his tail, skies his eyes, now takes him down. Never even touched his helmet. Helmet just flew off. Mouthpiece went one way, helmet went the other. Well, that's good football right there.
Nasty. Nasty looking hit.
Burleson had the pressure on. Granger made him throw a little bit early.
Granger 2 of 4, 4-yard passing. Throws it out in the flat, incomplete at the 22-yard line. Tim again underthrowing his intended receiver, Doug Carter.
Yeah, the coaches have to be shaking their heads. They got all the parts. This team is solid. They just need some consistency at quarterback.
You know, they talked about him throwing across his body earlier when we saw them in the season. Now they're saying that his elbow is a little too high because of that baseball motion that he throws with. I mean, it's just a matter of completing the passes when all is said and done.
Too much thinking. Just let that. He's a good athlete. Just let him go out and just start firing it. Don't think about where your elbow is.
Third down. And Granger's elbow is on the turf right now. Tackled at the 14 by Matthew Pearson. So it's fourth down and punting time for the Aggies. Loss of 7 on that sack by the Bears. We've just heard that Jason Matthews, the right tackle, starting right tackle for A&M, suffered a sprained ankle, and he will be back in the ballgame.
Well, he had a broken hand earlier. You know, he's the former tight end. They've got him playing right tackle.
A nice punt by Davis. Back to the 30. Brandell Jackson dancing his way up over the 45 down to the 49-yard line. We're going to take a short break after that 54-yard punt and 18-yard return. Stick around.
I'm Al Michaels. The Buffalo Bills are trying to get to the Super Bowl for the third straight year in a big game for them this Monday night as they're chasing the Miami Dolphins in the AFC East, and they'll send Jim Kelly, Thurman Thomas, James Lofton and company in against the New York Jets. The Bills and the Jets on ABC's Monday Night Football.
Sunday, Michael J. Fox and Christopher Lloyd are going
back to the future
all over again.
Picked off by Aaron Glenn. Aaron Glenn intercepts J.J. Joe, who is going up top on the first play after the punt. Glenn with his fourth interception of the season.
Not a bad play. You come out on first down, you let it fly. It's just not a well-thrown ball because the receiver was wide open. I will tell you this, Miller was behind everybody. The ball was just underthrown. Glenn was beaten again. Look at this. He's waiting. He might as well put his hand up and call a fair catch because that's how long he had to wait. Still a good play. They've been very balanced today, Baylor has. They've broken all tendencies. 152 yards rushing, 161 passing.
Granger back at the helm again, a quarterback. He tossed to Greg Hill. Got a block. And he's over the 20 out to the 22-yard line. A pickup of close to 3 yards. Michael McFarland made the tackle. Hill now, 9 rushes this afternoon for 63 yards.
Boy, did he ever get a block from Doug Carter. Brother of Michael Carter, the nose tackle for the San Francisco 49ers. He's 216 pounds, and I mean to tell you, that's the best block I've seen today.
You know, looking at Aaron Glenn, one of those junior college guys that has made a significant contribution here in his first year at Texas A&M. Slotin very happy with his progress. Granger under the heat and down under the heat back at the 12-yard line. The second sack of the afternoon for the Bear defense. Darryl Gardner that time made the stop.
Remember the other day talking to Grant Taft? He says, boy, I really like this guy, Gardner. 6'7", 262 pounds. He's only a freshman, but you can see the agility he has. Look at him. He's got that size, and yet look how fast he is. Streamlined guy.
Well, this edition of his team, the Baby Huey team, a boatload of freshmen on it.
Well, they call that Ant-Man front the eight-ball posse, and they've been all over it today.
Well, this might be the last play of the third quarter. Granger in the flat to Hill, and he got jacked at the eight-yard line. Michael McFarland put the hat on him.
He's the leader. He's the bell cow, the one they follow, and he sets the tempo. Tell you what, I think he put Hill's eyeballs in his forehead that time.
Punting time. As time runs out in the third quarter. The score is 14-13. Texas A&M's unbeaten streak in jeopardy right now with a tenuous lead of 1 point. We'll return with more action between Baylor and Texas A&M after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Not only is this Honda Accord designed to improve airflow, but cash flow as well. Introducing the Accord Lease Program. See your nearest dealer for details.
Hitachi. Wait, that's your phone.
Bonjour, here are the drawings.
Looks good from here.
Hello.
Okay, thanks.
Goodbye.
Take care.
Hitachi makes digital communication systems and 20,000 other amazing products. Hitachi.
Need a fresh start? Get the battery that's proven to start over 50,000 times. Motorcraft. Motorcraft quality parts from Ford.
Sunday, Michael J. Fox and Christopher Lloyd are going
back to the future
all over again.
Acrobat deja vu.
Back to the Future 2 Sunday.
Imagine if the dirt some gasolines leave on the inside of your engine started showing up on the outside. May we suggest Chevron with Tecraline? It has the cleansing power to help keep your car's performance spotless. Chevron, simply smarter.
The styling of the Infiniti Q45 has a beauty that increases as time passes. The interior offers a lasting pleasure, an enduring luxury, which is important because when it comes to a luxury car, as well as most other things in life, infatuation is easy. True love is what takes a little time.
Remember, reset your clocks back 1 hour Sunday.
A&M leading Baylor. We are just about to get the fourth quarter underway here as the Aggies will punt from their own end zone. David Davis standing about 5 yards deep. Now this is where he usually punts well. Trooper Taylor and Brandell Jackson back standing on their own 38-yard line for the punt. Another high spiral all the way back to the 35. That's Jackson. And he is brought down, mugged at the 43, a 56-yard boot, 7 yards on the return.
This place having a great time. The Aggie War Hymn in the spirit of Aggieland. These folks just enjoying themselves on a spectacular afternoon here at College Station. Look at this. Can't beat it. College football, a bit of Americana.
If you have never seen a game at College Station, this is the place to take one in. Joe on the toss. My, if he could have completed that pitch, there was some room on that corner.
You know why they do that, don't you?
Tell me.
They sway like that to make the opposing team seasick.
Gets to the announcers, too, a little bit. Marked high above the stadium here.
Baylor wilted in the fourth period. We told you about A&M earlier. They've outscored their opponent 65-11.
Second down and six. Baylor with the ball in the stack dive. Joe hands it off to the second back. That's Lewis. And Lewis will not be brought down all the way down to the 31-yard line. Tackled by Marcus Buckley and Patrick Bates. But he carried both of them on his 21-yard pickup.
Watch how they do this. Out of the eye now. Everybody starts to go right. Look at this. Now they come back with a little counter. And Lewis just breaks into the secondary. Now look at his power. He's got that low center of gravity. He's only 5'8", but he's well over 200 pounds. Holy ball.
First and 10. Joe hands it off to the fullback that time. They make it down to the 29-yard line. Tackle that time made by Eric England, the nose tackle for the Aggies. And looking at the third quarter statistics, things evening out on the scoreboard anyway.
Well, they really have, and if you look at total yards, they've evened out there somewhat, although BYU still has an advantage, but A&M has cut into it dramatically. Time of possession has gotten a lot closer too, but it still has been Baylor.
Joe keeps it himself and is tackled hard at the 28-yard line that time by Jesse Cox.
Staying with the statistics just for a second. Here we are in the final quarter with 13 and a half minutes left in the game. It's a one-point game, and you think twice. Baylor had it inside the one. Two different drives inside the one. Came away with no points. Then at the end of the half, they didn't have any time left on the clock. They could have kicked a field goal
at least. Third down and six to go. Miller and Bonner are the receivers. Joe tries to hit Bonner, and Manute Bull couldn't have caught that one.
No, and I think that's just the way he designed it. There was double coverage out on Bonner, so he threw it away. He's a very intelligent quarterback.
Now the question is, are they in field goal range? And will they go for it?
Well, the answer to that is yes. Whether they're in range or not, I don't know, but they're going to try, I think, for the field goal.
Trey Weir is going to attempt one from 47 yards out. game, 6 of 8, has improved by going 2 for 2 today.
Look at that. He just moved his holder up. It's going to be 46 yards. He says, I don't know if I can make a 47.
It'll still be a career long. And this will not make it. So another squandered scoring opportunity, although it was a long field goal. 14-13, A&M still leading.
It has four independent motors, an intricate steel frame, even an electronically regulated temperature control system. And that's just the driver's seat. The Lexus ES300 luxury sedan.
Our federal government has become a study in waste. A study in how elected officials cater to special interests rather than serve the interests of the American people. A bureaucracy that has poured $100,000 into a study of how to avoid falling spacecraft. $250,000 to study TV lighting for the U.S. Senate. And $19 million to study gas emissions from cows. The American people need to teach Washington a lesson in economics. We need to choose a candidate with a business sense to streamline spending and balance budgets. A candidate who will stop our government from throwing away our hard-earned money. This is no time to waste our votes on politics as usual. It is time for a candidate who will get down to business. It is time for Ross Perot.
They beat Notre Dame. Now Stanford has their sights set on number one Washington or other team conference matchups. It's regional action next Saturday on ABC's College Football.
Hey, look at this. Mount Aggie. Who needs Colorado, huh?
You said there was no surfing here, but look at this. Look where that is. It's right across the way from the stadium.
Yeah, but everyone watching the football game today. Mount Aggie. They all of, what, 400 feet elevation? If they
got everything here. They got skiing. You saw the tennis courts. Went to the baseball game the other night.
Great facilities, too. Had a chance to work out in the wonderful weight room.
You'd move here in a second just to stay near that barbecue.
Granger in at quarterback, hands it off to Greg Hill. Finds some room off tackle on that right side behind Matthews, and he's finally tackled by Albert Fontenot.
Granger to this point, 3 for 6, minus 8 yards. And then you see what Bullock did, 3 for 11, but at least he had positive yardage.
You know, in fairness to Granger, the guy is a winner. I mean, as ugly as his game can look at times, they're still 6-0.
Absolutely. He's a terrific athlete.
Drafted by the Minnesota Twins. Bullock now with the baseball cap on, watching. Greg Hill, close to the first down at the 38-yard line. Tackled by Lewis and Pearson. You know, John David Crow, a Heisman Trophy winner, now the athletic director here at Texas A&M. His trophy is on display in the building close by here. And Greg Hill actually likes to touch that trophy every time he passes it. Maybe figures it'll bring him some good luck.
A&M has had the Southwest Conference Player of the Year for the last 6 years, when you think Kevin Murray and Darren Lewis and Bucky Richardson. They could have him again in Hill. Hill and Thomas in the backfield. And now there's confusion.
Well, Thomas came in for Hill, but Granger stepped back and didn't like the looks of things.
But I think Hill was trying to come back out, and I think that's where the confusion was.
Well, RC will get it straight. We're going to take a timeout and get it straight, too.
1847, Werner Siemens opens his first factory and begins to manufacture the world's most advanced telegraph. That was then. This is now. Today, Siemens has 60 factories all across America, with over 15,000 manufacturing people, turning out an astonishing variety of high-tech electronic and electrical products with quality American industry can count on. Siemens, precision thinking.
In Europe,
things happen on time, right on schedule. Punctuality is the norm, and that makes Europe the ideal environment for UPS. Fact is, UPS has built the most comprehensive delivery network in Europe. So when you have a shipment going there that has to be on time, use the delivery company whose punctuality is a time-honored tradition. UPS. We run the tightest ship in Europe.
Every sports sedan is supposed to do well in the lane. But what about these lanes? At Lexus, we've achieved extremely tight tolerances between all major body panels. So not only does the ES300 look like it's put together well, it actually is put together well.
Well, the Battle of the Brazos has had many exciting finishes. Take 1986, A&M trailed most of the game until Kevin Murray hit Tony Thompson in the end zone right there for the touchdown. And the Aggies went on to win it 31-30. Baylor had one last chance, but couldn't get the points. Just a beautiful fall afternoon for a football game. Texas A&M perfect at 6-0, hoping to stay that way. And they lead 14-13. Love some of the uniforms that the guys wear around campus here. Greg Schorp in motion. Handoff is to Rodney Thomas, and he has the first down. A busy day of action. We saw the highlights from the Texas-Houston game. Jimmy Klingler throwing that vital interception as Texas wins it by a touchdown. Tech leads SMU, and Rice is all over TCU. Tim, a lot of speculation surrounding the future of the Southwest Conference and what direction they are heading in.
Well, you know, this league, Mark, has really suffered over the last decade. Six Southwestern Conference schools received sanctions. Grant Taft is the stabilizer in this league, and now he's going to become an athletic director.
That's Greg Hale out near midfield at the 49-yard line. Found a nice hole over the left side.
Arkansas moved over to the game. A lack of stability.
Greg Hale putting two hands on the ball that time.
Last week down at Texas, talking to some of the folks at the University of Texas, they think that Southwest Conference, as we know, will disband, and some of these people will move on either to the Pac-10 or the Big Ten or maybe the SEC.
And now this is Rodney Thomas breaking one up the middle. Down to the 35. A 16-yard pickup. As they lined up in their Lion offense that time with Thomas and Hill. Mike McFarland made the tackle that time.
Don't know what it is about this offense, but it just seems to explode in the fourth quarter. Look at the blocks, especially the one by Dawson right in the middle. That opened things up. Then the linebackers had to chase. That's one thing you don't want to do. You don't want to let this guy get going. You don't want to let people start chasing him because Thomas is so explosive, so elusive. You want to just pin him in and not let him get going.
Runs with those high knees. Greg Hill this time, the other half of the Lion offense, makes it down to the 33-yard line. Hill coming into the ballgame, averaging 97 yards per contest. Maston made the tackle that time.
Say, Maston, we haven't talked about him much. He had 12 tackles last week in the Houston game. He's a converted defensive back, quality player, the leading tackler on the weak side. But keep in mind, this defensive scheme is designed to force teams to go to the weak side to Maston. That's why he's the leading tackler, and he responds quite nicely.
Yeah, you're only supposed to lift weights two times a week during the season. He gets into the weight room five times a week. Greg Hill bouncing it outside, tries to cut it up down to the 25, where Chris Lewis makes the tackle, and Hill has a first down. It's Greg Hill time.
Well, they'll move the chains, too. They're starting to eat away at that clock, which is really become a major factor here. This defense for Baylor's played so well, but now it seems that the offense just starting to really dictate to them to take it after them.
Well, that Baylor defensive line, Tim, is outweighed by 16 pounds on average per man.
Seven plays in this drive, all runs, and you know the Texas A&M fullbacks are big enough to be tight ends.
again. Over the 25 down to the 23-yard line. Well, coming up next Saturday, more great college football action here on ABC. Number 16, Stanford, taking on number 1, Washington. That's going to be a very, very interesting matchup. Georgia against Florida and Ohio State against Iowa, 3:30 Eastern, all on ABC. Washington and Miami deadlocked in the polls once again. Stanford coming off a loss last week, too, against Arizona. Draw play, Greg Hill. Down to the 15, back to New York now. John Saunders with this update.
Mark, Georgia Tech in North Carolina in the ACC. Sean Jones trying to start things with a comeback. Jason McGill splits the defenders. They collide. Touchdown. It's 17-14 in the fourth. Mark.
Hey, with a name like Jones, you know he can play.
Once again, A&M trying to move the chains, and it looks like they've got enough for the first, or is it that close? Take that card out of your back pocket, put it in between the ball and the 10, see if they got it. He just kicked the football. Did you see that? He
first
kicked
down.
Hey, he kicked the football up to the thing.
Oh, boy. Well, to cop the cliche, pardon me, but it is a game of inches, and that little boot may have helped a little bit.
Watch the left foot hit that ball. Boom. All right, that puts it up there. Oh, he's got it now. First down.
But in fairness to him, it looked like the other official was still holding it.
Don't let the facts get away with a good story.
Not this time. First and 10 on the 15. That's Thomas. Down to the 11.5-yard line. Rodney Thomas running hard still. In Groveton, Texas.
Boy, when's the last time you've seen that? He actually came up, the referee, and indicated that there was still an inch to go. He goes back down, looks at it again, and says, oh, first down.
That's a tough job. Tough room.
8 minutes to go in this game, and that Baylor defense now has got to arch its back a little bit. It's got to come up with a big play. A&M dictating to him now with power football.
Two tight ends in. And that's Thomas again. This time, no success. He may have lost a couple of yards back at the 13, so the Baylor defense holds on that play. Nice surge that time coming from the right side.
Yeah, it really was. This young defensive line got it, got the penetration and let the linebackers fill, which is so important.
That tap, 21 years worth of great football at Baylor University. The end of an era coming, and he retires at the end of the season.
Well, he's going to take over as the athletic director, and I hate to see it. He is so good for the kids. He's a great teacher.
Third down and 8. Play action on the naked bootleg. Granger runs over a man into the end zone.
It's going to be called back for holding. There's a flag down.
There's a flag down on the 11-yard line, and it's against the Aggies.
Watch up front. There's Dawson, the center. His arms way, way around that shoulders. There's no question about that holding. That's a good call by the official.
Smile says it all, but little did he know about the flag. You know, that's the kind of toughness, though, that Granger has. We've seen him shake off tacklers during the course of the season. Make big plays in critical situations.
This is a huge third down for both sides.
17 to go. Have to get down to the 6-yard line. A handoff to Carter on the draw. And he will be far short of the first down, but they move it into the middle of the field. Chris Lewis and McFarland made the tackle.
12 plays on this drive, and they've all been runs.
Look at our game summary. Hill and Thomas running extremely well today, both over 100 yards.
Both quality backs, nice guys. Baylor.
Baylor, they will forever think about the two times they did not score inside the one-yard line. Terry Vinatulli is now from 37 yards out to give Texas A&M a four-point lead. And he's got it. With 6:25 to play, the Aggies lead 17-13. It's Baylor's turn when we come back.
Imagine for a moment a performance car. One with a four cam, 32 valve, 250 horsepower V8.
Got any plans yet?
Few?
No celebrity spokesman.
I'm opening a restaurant.
No beach volleyball games.
How about another Heineken?
No lengthy description of the brewing process. None of that is what made Heineken the number one imported beer in America.
You got that steady paycheck?
Oh, yeah.
I got a few bucks put away.
So you want to own a restaurant?
No, what I really want to do is be a relief pitcher.
I'm paid to buy the high-volume copiers. I don't want to have to worry about them.
The corporate line from Canon.
It's simple. If our copiers are working, our people are working.
High-volume copying systems so reliable, you don't have to think about them.
All I want to know is it keeps copying, sorting, stapling. End of story.
The corporate line from Canon. The number one copier company. And the new power in high-volume copying.
Plays on. Baylor Bear Band and the Battle of the Brazos. 17-13, the Aggies lead, and they're getting set to kick it off. This is the River War. Fighting over bragging rights over the Brazos River.
Well, you touched on it earlier. This whole thing started so long ago because when this was an all-military school, the guys used to go up to Baylor to get dates. Well, the Baylor folks didn't like that.
No, sir.
That started everything.
Randell Jackson back deep. Vinatulius to kick it off. Jackson 5 yards deep. Will settle for the touchback. Oh, we will have time, so stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report featuring scores and highlights from across the country after the ballgame. But we still have a lot of time to play. 6:25 remaining.
12th man, Julius Holly. We've been keeping an eye on. He watched number 12. Got pretty good speed right there.
That was sure.
Good little move. Look at him. Yeah, show a little something.
First and 10 for J.J. Joe and the Bears at the 20. Bonner to the far sideline and fights his way nicely for a first down to the 32. He tried to shake Derek Frazier but carried him a couple yards for the first.
Time now a factor because on that last A&M drive,
Brent Taft got floored on the sideline there.
Well, we saw Don James break his jaw in the game. Guy ran out of bounds, got him. Grant took a shot here.
But
watch this. Here comes Bonner. Here comes the pursuit. A&M guys go over the side. Bang, they roll right up into the coach. Look at the coach going down. Well, lucky he didn't lose his knees.
He's been shot at a lot of times in his career.
I'm sure that was going to make A&M ate up 6 minutes and 54 seconds on their drive. So here comes Baylor now.
First and 10 wide open to the far sideline. Reggie Miller complete.
But Mark, it's that first down we talked about. They pick up 9 on first. Brings up 2nd and 1. That's a go-to down. You can do anything now. You can run, pass. You know you can always come down on 3rd and get that yard.
And the play comes in from Coach Tav. Hey, Coach, straighten up that tie. Let's go. shaking his head, figuring, hey, it is time to get out of coaching, huh?
Penn State leading West Virginia by three. Nittany Lions in another battle.
Pickup of nine on first down, second and one. Joe keeps it on the option that time and falls forward for the first down at the 43-yard line. But boy, after 21 years of this rough stuff, maybe it is time to get out, huh?
Here's Cap in the blue shirt and the hat. Watch this now. He's just kind of easing up and all of a sudden, whoop. Hey, he came down hard on that shoulder, too.
Took one for the team.
You know, Grant's no young chicken anymore. He can't take those hard hits like he used to.
Six times the Southwest Conference Coach of the Year. And still going and going and going. Bonner in motion. First and 10 for J.J. Joe, the draw play. And they push it out a couple of yards. That was Kendrick Bell. Over the 45 down to the 46-yard line.
That's good. See, now there's a penalty against Baylor, though, and that will negate what was a very strong first down 5 yards. Throwing the second penalty against Baylor this game.
The Bears came in 4-3 overall and 3-1 in the conference. A win here would be huge. That goes without saying. So that'll set up first down and 15 to go. Things pretty much even in the second half in terms of yardage. But A&M has taken the lead back. Baylor came in averaging 402 yards per contest. Joe looking for Bonner, but he's covered. Buckley. And he throws it away. And a flag down. A late one back at the 18-yard line. Grounding or not?
J.J. Joe says no.
There were two receivers right
there.
The
official says, well, he's going to talk things over here.
Reggie Miller looked like he was in the neighborhood on that play.
You can't make that call. Come on.
That's what it is.
Well, what he's saying is that Joe was in the grasp and was throwing. He was on his way down and threw it just to avoid the sack. No, no way. He was throwing it away, there's no question. But that's not his, you can't throw a flag on that because they had receivers out there.
Reggie Miller wasn't too far off. So they back it up all the way back to the 12-yard line as Tech defeats SMU in Southwest Conference play. Robert Holland, gang, getting it going.
It's now second down and about 40.
Second down in Houston to go.
They better call a timeout here. He got it. Play clock was down to 1 second. He had to call that or be penalized.
Baylor may be losing a touch of its poise right here. J.J. Joe going off to the sidelines to talk it over with the coach.
It is uncanny how Texas A&M can turn the momentum in a football game in the fourth quarter.
Just keep thinking that one of these times it's going to come back and bite them, though. Playing all these close games. Next Saturday on ABC Sports, Fred Couples, Tom Kite, the PGA Tour's top 30 money winners take aim at the season's biggest prize. Tour Championship, $2 million at stake. And then ABC's College Football presents regional action. Stanford, Washington, Georgia against Florida, or Ohio State against Iowa. 3:30 Eastern, 2:30 Central on ABC. Just a wonderful week we've had here at College Station, Texas. Boy, they even have a golf course on campus here. Too bad some of us have to work. A sellout crowd of over 70,000 on hand to witness this one. The Aggies have not lost to Baylor since 1985. flag's down, and so is Joe, taken down hard by Sam Adams. Pardon me, Joseph Aspel.
Sam Adams could have a Lombardi in his future. People compare Adams to former Aggie Ray Childress, Houston All-Pro, but Adams came through cleanly and really took a shot at J.J. Joe.
Yeah, I'm telling you. Baylor's got a nice drive going, Tim, but they're going in the wrong way. They got it in reverse. Second down and 45. Roger Riley, get out the calculator.
You know, speaking of Sam Adams, last year A&M had the most patriotic line I had ever seen. It's Sam Adams, Patrick Henry, and England, the nose guard. They still have England and Adams.
Quarterback draw by J.J. Joe. Nice move, but he's taken down at the 15-yard line. Gets out of bounds to stop the clock with 4:55 remaining. The clock now becomes a bit of an enemy of this Baylor squad. Bates made the tackle.
Now, see, they can't panic. They still, a touchdown wins it for them, and they've got 4:55. What they have to do now is get themselves some punting room here. They don't want to give A&M good field position, especially after they ate up more than 6 minutes on that last drive.
Well, they got back 7 of those yards on that play. Mims checking out of the ball game. Third down and 38. Adams almost got to Joe, and now he throws complete to the 30-yard line, but there's a flag down. That was Melvin Bonner that made the catch. Flag down on the far side of the field at the 27, a pickup of 13 that time on the catch by Bonner.
Field position play. They wanted to get it up so they could get a good punt out of there and back A&M up.
25 seconds.
Oh, a delay of gain.
Unbelievable. When does it end? You have to ask yourself if you're Grant Taft. Seems like they've had the ball forever, but they haven't been able to move it forward.
I come up with something a little bit different here, maybe a reverse or something like that, just to see if you can break a big gainer.
Well, they scored 2 touchdowns last week.
Only trouble is, when you're backed up like this, you don't want to gamble with a crazy play.
And still plenty of time remaining. Third down and 42.
Jam him! Jam him up!
Now they put 10 seconds back on the clock.
A lot of questions surrounding this Baylor team coming into the ballgame. They'd only defeated one squad with a record over 500.
You know, as R.C. Slocum, who I admire a great deal as a coach, evaluated the rest of the schedule, he looked at it and he said, "Will, we should win the rest of our games."
First, though, to deal with Baylor, and Joe is going to take the safety. Does that surprise you, Tim?
No, it doesn't. As a matter of fact, you were down there with Grant and I were talking about this in the pregame. He says, "Hey, Tim, if we're backed up like this, we're going to take the offensive safety." He did it last year. It still keeps him within a touchdown. Still keeps within a touchdown, but it's field position. You don't want to do anything crazy. You don't want to give the game away. Let's take it back up. We'll get a free kick. We'll try to back them up a little bit rather than give them good field position. Then we'll let the defense get us the ball back. We'll go into the touchdown and win it. That's his philosophy. We'll see if it works.
Becoming a bit of a chess match.
When you publish thousands of newsletters a week, color is out of the question.
Invest in the fastest highlight color laser printer and come to a different conclusion. Intelligent color for any document, only from Xerox.
Our sales figures were confusing. No one understood them.
With our digital color copier, you get the clarity of color with the stroke of a pen and touch of a screen. Intelligent color for any document, only from Xerox. Putting it together.
Sears, America's number one name in hardware, is having its biggest sale of the season. This 51-piece Craftsman Mechanics tool set with case, only $39.99. and a 19-piece screwdriver set, 4-piece plier set, or a 9-piece combination wrench set. All Craftsman. All your choice. Just $19.99. All made in America. Guaranteed forever.
You can count on me.
And there are more great values during the Sears National Hardware Sale.
Pre-recorded to demonstrate a remarkable point. A car phone so well conceived, it's not only portable, but voice activated. Now, dialing's as easy as this. Call office.
Thank you for calling Lexus. May I help you?
Hey, we were down on the field before the game, and it is hot down there.
Those are real fans.
Hey, how about this now?
Oh, my.